Good evening, members.
Good evening.
So welcome to today's session on strategies to grow CA practice. For this we have two well-known speakers from Guru and Jana. So I would like to invite Sri Guru sir to the dais and Sri Lakshman to the dais. Before I hand over the session, so a brief introduction about today's speakers. Guru sir is the founder of Guru Anjana, a chartered accountancy firm. A firm which is only firm in India to file tax returns on 1st April and a paperless and lockless CA office. They have global thought leadership awards from Accounting Bulletin Awards. Guru Anjana have a vision to be admits the top 20 CA firms in India by 2020. Sir has very wide experience. So he is a founder of Guru and Jana from 2003 to till date. He is a founder of Vardhan from 2014 to till date. A boutique social responsibility advisory firm with JV with Rafa USA. He is a founder in Pathway from 2018 to till date. A SEBI registered angel investment fund and also a partner in Aparna and Anathan from 1994 to 2003. He is a partner of the firm, headed corporate law and accounting functions in the firm. And he has wide vast educations like he is a CA from ICAI, he is also a Bachelor of Commerce and a law graduate from Bangalore University. He has also completed advanced management program from IIM Bangalore and also qualified insolvency professional registered under Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. And he is also part of various organizations like he is a trustee of IIMB Alumni Trust, convener of IIM Blue 2018, member of Accounting Standards Board, independent director in over 10 companies, author of God in the Boardroom, Banter Beyond the Buck and 8 Technical Guides issued by ICAI. He represents India subcontinent in the HLBI Global Tech Group. He is also a board advisor to Vishwakarma University, Pune. With this brief introduction, I welcome you to the next session, sir. And next speaker is C.A. Sri Lakshmi. She is also an insolvency professional, chartered accountant, company secretary, MSc in psychology, masters and bachelors in commerce, received gold medal from Azim Premji sir. Her professional experience includes, so currently partner at Guru and Jana chartered accountancy firms, and she is heading India Entry Services Corporate Governance, Payroll and HR Function. Earlier part of BMR Advisors for a brief period. She has various interests and which includes founder member of CAPS Foundation and volunteer of Mahatriya Guru and Jana Foundation, conducts campus placements for BCom students along with career guidance, written articles in a self-help growth magazine, Infinity Thoughts, circulated in 35 plus countries, has spoken at ICAI on dividends and funding options for NGOs. Further than EIR, radio show and Power TV, she is a regular trainer at Toyota for shop floor employees and on financial discipline. She co-edited the 3 books published by Guru and Jana. With this brief introduction, I welcome you to today's seminar.
Actually, you were supposed to speak where I was supposed to speak for 1.5 hours and then she was supposed to speak. Then we felt the audience will be too bold because this is the December audience, they are only come for coming for CP, ready to see. So they will be really, really bold if one breaks, speaks for 1 hour and they'll go off after they sign. So we thought, let us intermix each of us and I will do a few slides and she do a few slides, so all of us. So we are visible in the... Okay, because last time the angle went off somewhere, I was not visible.
Sort of slides. So in case you guys get bored, it can become very difficult. But I would request to just play with the session. Be with us when we have been seeing the session. I've been in profession for 30 years also now. And we have failed more number of times than we have succeeded. So at least we can definitely tell you where we failed, if not the fact that where we succeeded. Having said that, we will try to give you some introspection exercises as we do this, because we are talking of a subject which is not related to taxation, or we are talking of a subject which is not related to our regular profession. We are talking of a subject which is relating to our lives. So as far as possible, let it be an interactive session. Keep interfering whenever you would like to, keep telling your hands up and things like that, and do keep asking questions. Before we start, if all of you can just look at this Kahoot.it, Kahoot.it on your mobile. You can open your Safari or Google, or some of you can possibly download the app, but you can actually do it on the web. Kahoot.it is a small tool, so if you want, I can use the mic only instead of the computer. Am I audible guys now? So if you can just keep this, what we will do is at the end of, we have 5-6 chapters in this. At the end of every chapter, let's try to do an introspection exercise relating to our particular offices. How many of you here are in practice? All of you. The gentleman behind, you are not in practice? All in practice. Okay. That means mostly all of us are in practice. All of us are in practice. And many of the things, whatever we would discuss today, could be very, very elementary. It could be very stupid in many cases. But at the same time, we will try to throw light on some aspects which you might not have thought. The entire 100 slides, I am 100% sure everybody sitting here know it. Not that anybody does not know it. The only problem would be you might not have used it, or you might not have realized it. That is the only difference. All of you sitting here would, without a doubt, know it. So, and when I can stand here, it's been 30 years since I started profession, close to 27 years technically. And if you see the photograph in the right, that was for our first office. And we didn't have a full-fledged office, we could hire 2 tables. And it used to be such a funny situation that we didn't have claims. In case any claim comes, we didn't have a check. So I had one table and my partner Jana used to sit on that side. Whoever comes first, we sit that side and this side. As soon as a claim comes, one of us will pick up the file until income tax goes away. There is no income tax hearing, no claim, no business. We just pick up the file and go off. And we'll be standing outside or sitting in some Aditya hotel and waiting for the claim to go, because we don't have another chair to occupy to that fellow. So that's how we started practice, and when we started practice, Bangalore was not so elaborate. There were very rarely that we used to get claims. Private limited companies would be a rarity. There was nothing called VC funds. There was nothing called angel funds. There was no investment happening. There was nothing called startup ecosystem. Software was not there. So if you can imagine, there was hardly anything in Bangalore when we started. So from there has been a whole lot of economic development, and that's been very useful for us. And how did we ride? The entire ride would be very wide. Now the picture on the left is our current office. The current office is around 25,000 square feet. Both the buildings represent our office. I can do it. And please do ask whatever you require. Kindly don't think that it is some sort of income tax scrutiny where it's a one-way traffic. Please interfere, interrupt. I would like to have your views. Many of you may not accept what we are telling here. You may tell it is bullshit.
Some of you may accept, yes, what you tell is right. So please keep interfering. How much ever you want, the more you interfere, the better it is for us. We have 100% software licenses. Why I am telling this is, from that stage, is it possible to reach at this stage? And when we started our profession, there were not many CA firms which had 25 people. There were not many CA firms which had 40 people. And it was never heard that, yeah, we hired a chartered accountant. There was never a chartered accountancy firm to hire unless it was a big four. There was a very low possibility that other domestic firms could hire chartered accountants. Could be 1, 2, 3, 4. Not in larger numbers. And it would never be a situation that I could not enter my boss's cabin. I still remember when we were sitting down with Panindra there, the chairman's seat was vacant, the chairman was not there today. So she was standing almost close to the chairman. I told, you can't sit there. I had a situation where in my office I was knowing a little bit of computers. Those days we had MS-DOS and things like that. I was trying to operate my boss's computer because he doesn't know how to operate. And by chance, after standing for 10 minutes or 15 minutes, I sat in his chair. That's all hell broke loose. I had done some blasphemous act in the world. How can you sit in my chair? How is it possible that you can sit in my chair? We couldn't even do anything, but today's world is not like that. There's nothing called it's my cabin, it's my chair. It's a very evolved world. At this point of time, I may not be big enough to tell no to a claim. We got a very large bribery claim, extremely large bribery claim. We can't do this work. I would not like to earn money from somebody who is doing bribery and liquor around here, and I would not like to do. Similarly, we did the same thing with a large cigarette factory. Came and approached us, we told we don't want to do work for you. But incidentally, that became very beautiful for us because they called us to Calcutta. Who is this clown who is telling no to the largest cigarette manufacturing company in the country? Who is this clown who is telling no? So we went to Calcutta and asked, why do you want to tell them? But I am not interested in doing your work because of this reasons. Then as it stands out to be, today we handle most of their hotel chains in South India. So I may not be large enough to tell no to a claim. Today also we run around to do a profession tax registration. We want to do a shops and establishment work. And we don't have outsourcing. We purely are into traditional practices. We do auditing, we do MIS, we do compliances, we do taxation work, we do corporate work. We don't have a single work which goes out of the profession. And we try to do everything. I can't restrict myself to tell, okay, I just am doing an audit firm. And all through the 100 slides, whatever, we don't get scared, 100 slides will go just like this. Don't get scared when I'm telling 100 slides. All through this, every single activity can be implemented by us today and now. I am not trying to be futuristic and telling, okay, we will try to do it after 3 months, after 6 months, after 2 years. Let us build up something and do it. There is absolutely nothing of that. Every single job, whatever we want to discuss today, can be done today and we can do it now. If there is something which requires a much larger thought process, we have not even included in this slide. So we have tried to make it as much as implementable as possible. And I really did not have any time to prepare it. Yesterday she was asking where is the presentation, and I was dictating on WhatsApp to my secretary what all she has to put in. It took around 25 minutes to spell it out. Today morning she gave me the PPT at around 1. We both ran through this for half an hour and we are here. We went to Chandrika, had coffee and came here. So I have not spent time on preparing this presentation. And in case I am referring to our firm, kindly don't mistake me. I am not expecting any clientele from any of you sitting here. I am not expecting any business sitting here. I am only trying to justify that it can be done this way. So it might give examples relating to our office because I don't know any other office. After my stint with PwC, I just started practice. I don't know any other office other than this. And the pudding speaks for itself. From the last 2003 is the way we started Guru Anjana. From 2003, annually we are growing at the rate of 40-50% every year. We are around 380 people with 91 chartered accountants as of today. And by 2020, we will be around 440. We are not keen on acquiring firms at all. Generally grow in an organic manner. Just to give you a perspective of how small the practice is, if you look at this statistics of the institute, more than 10 partners for a country of 1.3 billion people.
there are only 135 firms, more than 10 partners. And if you look at all the 10, and if you look at all this, more than 11 partners, 76 firms. If you look at 25 partners, maybe zero. So even if you total up all these things, there are not even more than maybe 400 firms or 500 firms which are a critical mass. They are not more than 500 firms. And again, in this is as per the Institute website. We don't even know how many are actual firms, how many are construct firms. I met somebody in, when I was going there, I met somebody in North, and they were telling how many partners you are. I think we are 16 partners. So how do you do partners meeting? We don't do partners meeting. So when is the last time you met? Once in a while we'll meet. Fair enough. When is the last time you met this partner? Then he came back to 4 years ago. So these are construct partnership firms only for the purpose of getting C&AG audit, bank audits. There are not partnership firms. They are all proprietary firms joined together to represent to the government, telling them, okay, we are all together. So if you look at this entire thing, there is a huge potential waiting out there. And the entire potential is based on the fact that are we a chartered accountant or are we a professional management company? So when we started in 2003, we didn't have any work. All put together, we were three people, hardly any files, and there was no growth. So from 2003 to 2010, we did a whole lot of work. I worked really, really hard. Sorry, I need to keep sitting often. So there was a whole lot of stuff which happened from 2003 to 2009, working 17 hours, 18 hours. And 2010, when we started looking at it, how come we are not growing? There must be something wrong. Then we also observed around that there are not many large firms at all in the country. Who are the large firms? There must be the Brahmayas of the world or the Ramadhyanis of the world. Who are the emulating firms? Other than that, there were not many large firms which were actually built up as a 400 people firm or a 100 chartered accountants firm. There must be something wrong. So I contacted my boss, who was the Professor Sundar Rajan in Indian Institute of Management. And he told, no, Guruji, we are all professionals doing our profession. We have been so involved in the taxation work, we are so involved in the articulation of subsection 3. None of us have the time to actually grow our profession. But I am struggling from 9 years, sir, I have not done anything much. What do you want me to do? But if you have the courage, why don't you drop office for 1 year and come to IIM, study for a year's time? But sir, seat sigata. But you are a chartered accountant, why don't you get a seat? Come over here. And how much is the course? For 5.5 lakhs. When I came back to the office, our total turnover in 2009 was around 55 lakhs. Or 50 lakhs. If 50 lakhs is the turnover for 4 partners, each partner maximum can take home 7-8 lakhs per annum. In 7-8 lakhs, I have to take care of my family, my car, my house, loan. Only how do I afford a 5 lakh course? Then we decided, okay, this year you guys take the profit. I don't want the profit, I'm going back to school. So 1 year I spent time in IIM, and the entire perspective of profession changed. The first time I realized in IIM that, oh, is there an appraisal system? Is it? I thought I just gave an increment. What is this appraisal system stupid about? Oh, do I have to take care of my brand? Is it? I'm talking in the institute, that should be good enough. What do you mean by take care of the brand? So there was a total perspective which changed. So from a turnover of around 48, 49 lakhs, within a period of 9 years, we have touched around 30 crores. And that's been a fantastic growth for us. And we have not done anything other than profession. Income tax assessment, sales tax assessment, GST returns, ROC filings. Not even a single job we have done other than profession. We don't have a outsourcing center, we don't have a data center. Zero. Zilch. So even if you look at, oh, something happened. If you look at the number of firms there, around 90,000 people, approximately in statistics, I got from the institute as a people, must be it has become another 2,000. So I'm trying to tell, even in a city like Bangalore, there may be 8-10,000 chartered accountants who come for election voting. Sir, 10,000, sir? How many voting in Bangalore? 13,500. And how many in practice, sir?
Practice 4,000.
So 4,000 in practice for almost a population of 1.2 crores. That's a huge, huge competency available for us. So it is, having said that, it's very easier said than done. Even if it is a all action, it takes time, it takes effort. It's not so easy to just go ahead and implement things. Second, there are many people sitting here, the first thing whenever we talk about a new strategy or a new technology or a thing, they'll tell, okay, I have a new youngster in the office, on a kot marsa. There's a new guy in the office, let me try to give it to him. He has to drive the firm. I'm not going to drive the firm. So that could never work. Anything has to happen, it is the team sitting here which has to be done. We can't just pass on the buck to anybody. Now today I head the firm. I can never tell one small job I will not push it. I have to do it all my life. There's nothing stating that I can just push it and walk out of it. And I'm a specialist at everything. I'm an income tax specialist, I'm a transfer pricing specialist. Those days are gone today. Today income tax law itself may change. We don't know where it's going to stop, where it's going to end. That extreme high level of specialization is required if he's a specialist at job. But for running the organization, we require an organization day. We require a management day. Have you ever wondered that in thousands of chartered accountants we have, like, it's something like this bungee jumping. When you look at a bungee jumping, it's so easy. It looks, but when you go and stand there, you know what is bungee jumping. So whatever point you are telling, it's pretty easy for you. It's so easy, I can do it. But when we step down and do it, it's not as easy as that. So two caveats. One, for people who came a little late, please open a website called Kahoot, KAHOOT.IT, Kahoot.IT, because that's a sort of a introspection session we do after everything. The small tool in a website, Kahoot.IT. You'll not get anything because I'll have to give you a password to enter. I'll give you a password as it comes. Sir, good evening, sir. So then I'm telling you in the first slide that every single thing can be implemented by the audience here. I'm 100% right. Every smallest thing, we have not included even a small thing which cannot be implemented. Having said that, to implement it requires a tremendous amount of effort. Nothing will change, even you can't change a visiting card without an effort. There's an effort required in the profession. Seldom I always think that, except in the chartered accountancy fraternity, we are all so proud that we have passed the toughest exam ever. One of these, my classmate, we both did CA together. We are all so proud that we have done the toughest ever exam in the world. But having said that, I've never seen a large organization built by a chartered accountant. Why is it only an MNC firm will have to come here and establish a practice and become a big firm? Not that they are bad, they are also good. But having said that, why is it an Indian firm cannot become an MNC? And I'm not claiming that we might become an MNC. But this is a thought process. There are very few chartered accountants which has become an organization. Very, very few of them, handful of them. And when we look at each of the situations, everything looks to be very, very achievable. There's nothing which is not achievable. Something happened. Oh. So I'll hand over, as I told you, we'll both flip and flop so that all of you stay alert throughout the session. We'll do a flip and flop and he takes some slide, I'll come back, I'll take some slides and we'll jump over on that. Incidentally, she is Sreelakshmi, he didn't introduce her properly. She is so educated that she is the highest qualified in our entire office. And she was, we were in aerobics class. And she used to be in the front, I used to be in the guy's side, and almost 5-6 months she didn't talk to me. Oh, then who is this? Then one fine day she came and told, you are Guru Prasad from Guru Anjali. I told, I am Guru Prasad. I was thinking she is some article student. And she told, no, I am also a chartered accountant, I practice on my own. So as she stands today, she is already 14-15 years of post-qualification experience. She is short and small like me, but she is 14-15 years post-qual. And she heads the corporate law in the office, she heads the payroll, and taking care of HR of 380 people is not an easy task. And our attrition rates right now is around 3.5-4%. So a lot of credit goes to her, she takes care of the HR also.
Thank you so much, Guru. So the chairman has come, probably I will take the opportunity to welcome him or something. Sure, sir. I think he was supposed to talk before us, so would you like to? So I thank all the office bearers for giving us an opportunity. Last week also I was here, I was talking something on corporate law. And they had already fixed Guru's session for today. And while talking during the lunch break, they overheard a couple of chartered accountants telling the second session speaker spoke really well. So immediately the office bearers called me and they told there is one session next week. It is on strategies on how to build CA practice. But before that, it was called how to build a global firm. And I said, we are a local firm, so I won't know how to build a global firm. If you're asking me how to build a global firm, I'm sorry, I'm not the right person for you on the topic. Then they said, no, please ask your other partner. He's already agreed to talk. The first session is his. So second session, you can come there. Then I realized Guru was already committed to talk here. And then I said, okay, since Guru is there, one, I'll be a little nervous because he's the founder partner. But two, I know he'll always be there to support me. He can watch my back. So I don't have to worry even if I falter. And as he was telling already, until 3-5 today, he didn't give me the presentation. Because the last week presentation, I had given quite hell for 8 hours, bothering all my partners, what are the practical topics I should talk, what are the issues each one of you is facing, please let me know. So he said, no matter what, today he will give me the slides only at 3 o'clock. So the whole presentation has been formulated by Guru, so he entirely knows how it goes. But in this, there are some bits of value add that I have also done. So we'll take you through this presentation. We'll try to make it interactive. We'll really try to make it practical on how it can be useful. And you'll all have some takeaways from this session which you can go back and implement. And to see so many of you come here on a Wednesday evening, and I think there is a beautiful mix, right from the young chartered accountants to some of the people who are probably my age and then some very senior people. So maybe all the senior people I'm thinking have come here for Guru, but thank you so much for making it. We'll definitely give you some points for you to take it away. We have built this whole presentation on these 10 slides. So this itself looks interesting. What we are saying is things which work. We will give you some sure shot formulas which we will work, which we have tried ourselves, which we have implemented, which we have seen how it can add value to clients as well as to the people in the organization. Then the organization structure, how probably an organization structure plays a very critical role for the people of the organization, how they can grow, how the partners can give a roadmap for the people who are reporting to them, how each one can grow. Very interesting thing I have to tell you, organization structure. 3 years back when I was interviewing an article, lot of articles come, and when I asked him, do you have any questions? The whole rounds was over and he was pretty smart, he knew very good English. He came from one of the very good colleges and had a good English schooling and was from Bangalore only. So that way that kid was top class. And I asked him, do you have any questions for me? Is there something you want me to clarify for you? And he asked me, when will I become a partner if I join your firm? I didn't know the answer. I paused for 10 seconds. First time some article was asking me, how many years will it take for me to become a partner in your firm? Then I beat around the bush, then I told something. Then I thought actually that kid was rude. How can he ask me such a question? But then I realized today's kids are like that. Today's kids will come to us and ask so many things which we probably did not have the courage to ask when somebody was interviewing us. So the times have changed. So that way we felt organization structure is going to play a vital role. The third is the legal and veto structure. Anything we do needs to be backed up in black and white. It cannot be something which is unwritten law. After us what? We are in such a phase where we want the organizations to grow after us. We leave a legacy. It's not that Guru started the firm, then his son joined, then his son's son will join, the grandchild will come. So that's not why the firm was built. So that way the legal and veto structure is important. Then the organization character. We've all heard of having characteristics for individuals. That way the organization represents the management, so we can build an organization structure too. Have we thought of our organization in that way? How can we build a subconscious mind for an organization? That becomes important. Segmentation and positioning. Segmentation all of us will know. what sort of segment we want to be in, how do we service. Like Maruti, when it came, Maruti is not in the luxury segment. Maruti is in a clear mid-segment car sort of a segmentation. So how, when we introduce a service, when we introduce a product, what can be the segment we want to be in and how are we going to position ourselves? New areas you can venture into. Today, I think disruption is largely the key and the word. Gone are the days when people used to tie a watch. Now today we have to see time, we see only the mobile. So that way too many things have undergone a huge transformation. We've seen how the country is progressing, we've seen how technology is playing a huge role. So in that sense, how the chartered accountants of today can be in the game is what we're going to talk here. New areas we can venture into. Death of old times. So a lot of things have changed. We'll see how the death of old times is going to help us or what we are going to do there. HR strategies. The HR strategies, I could think of 100, 120 that we do in our firm. But we have made it very simple in terms of how you can plan when we are a 5-member, 10-member, 15, 20-member team in the organization to 40, 50, 60, how you can scale it up. So some bit of strategies are there for us to help in growing. Tech strategies. Our tech strategies is headed by Guru. And tech is one of the very important verticals in the firm. So how tech also today plays a really big role, we can see. And business strategies. On business strategies, you will find a lot of anecdotes. You will find a lot of instances which Guru is going to share with us. So the next three slides are going to give us 9 points on mandatorily what are the things that are going to work. It can be a formula where we add 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus and all the things and we come up with a big synergy. That is what we are going to see in the next three slides. What we always think we should do. How many of us here, when we go for a BD pitch, think of a marketing plan? Or when we are going to get some clients, how many of us here really sit down and make a plan? Any show of hands? There are some very nice. So some of us sit and make a marketing plan. So we'll see what this plan can be. But what I'm saying is, first having a plan is very critical. Let's have a marketing plan. Getting referrals. What are the referrals we are talking of? Referrals of our own clients. Where our clients are going to speak good about us, our clients are going to carry our good name, and any the moment a client thinks of who is a CA that he can refer, he'll become his own CA. He'll tell that client has been, the CA has been helping and he's been doing a good job. So the existing clients are going to become very good referrals. So we have to make sure that we will keep them and sometimes, you know, make a call to them and find out are things going right. In an organization, there will be the top 20% of our clients who are going to bring in 80% of revenue into the organization. So are we making sure that we are keeping in touch with them? Maybe. Can we host a dinner for them or can we host a lunch for them? Or I know a law firm who regularly calls people to the 5-star hotels for a dinner meet or for a breakfast meet, or they tie up with some legal firms outside India and they host together some conferences. So these places they call their clients over a drink or over a nice cocktail, lunch, anything. So they call and they make sure that they are in the mind share of the client. So the client actually once in a while thinks about their chartered accountant too. So are we talking of referrals here from our own existing clients? Well, of course, first most important thing is that we render quality services, and through rendering quality services, they will think of us as reference for the future clients that we are going to get. Brand your accounting firm. Now, we as a firm brand ourselves in several ways. We are bound by the code of ethics, and we cannot do too many things which are out of the box, and so many we have to follow that we should not deviate from what is written in the code of ethics. So as a brand, what are we doing? As a brand, we can do. I'm telling a few things which we do, which you might resonate with also. One, we say we are a paperless office. The moment we say we are a paperless office, everybody's eyes twinkle and they sit up. They ask, how can a CA firm be paperless? And if you see the age-old CA firms, first thing that you see predominantly when you enter a CA office is a stack of papers. So that we say we are a paperless firm. And how do we do it? We have a digital room, we scan all records, we put it in one place. Then we bring out some publications of the firm. We don't actually write a GST book, we don't write Companies Act, we don't write taxation books. No, we don't write that. So, we can say a brand that way, we do a lot of things. And can brand be one of the things on how we are going to brand some of the points? So I request Guru to chip in here because he has some points.
No, you can continue. Finish up the stage.
Okay. Develop marketing materials. What are the marketing materials we can develop? We have some marketing materials like how to do business in India. So when you go meet a client, you can give him some brochures or some materials which we talk of. What are the practices, what are the services that the firm renders, then what are some of the materials which we can use, and we show basically that we are there and we are doing a lot of work. That is one of the things. Then improve your website. Website of course is one of the first ways which people will come to us. They Google search, they find out who is the best CA firm in Bangalore, and they will see that some of them have given Google ratings, some top things are being said on the internet. Then there is this glass door where people write about, employees write about how the firm is. So these sort of things are going to be there. So there we actually play a role in developing the website of the firm. How many of us here don't have a website? Some of us here don't have a website. So we can think of having a website. So one thing I'm saying here is, okay, let's spend a lot of money and build a website. I'll come to some important things in the next slide. Then network more. What do you mean by network more? We have these Toastmasters clubs, we have this BNI, we have some of the CA forums like here, and a lot of networks there are like Rotary Club is one of the networks. So these networks can actually play a role in helping us get some clients. So some of these networking practices we can follow where we are a part of social media. Today social media is a very important aspect. We have something called the Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. Are we on all these places? LinkedIn. Can we actually write some articles? Can we spend some time on creating a web page for Facebook? So many things in the social media are also there. Now for instance, when we do a Diwali celebration, can we put out some photos in Facebook where a lot of people are going to see what we are doing? And these you can simply create not as the firm Facebook page but as HR page of your firm. So a lot of within the code of ethics and within the whatever the institute guidelines is given, only through that you should think of what you can do and then come up with social media. Then offer community services. What do you mean by offer community services? Then as an office, can you organize a cleaning drive for the locality you are in? Like Youth for Parivartan comes up with that clean the road and clean a corner of the city. So can you actually go work with them, get your employees involved, get the public involved, and paint the wall there and put a line telling sponsored by so and so. So can you think of that one of the initiatives? Then can you do a blood donation camp? Can you think of doing some eye pledging? So this ways somewhere can you be there as a presence is what we can see. Consider paid advertising. So paid advertising here is the challenge. And how can we today compete with the big multinational firms where we know that they sponsor things like Wimbledon's? So that way paid advertising is quite a challenge, but paid advertising is one of the things. Now what is in the last three slides would take fabulous business development is what we are saying. If this is what we thought in the last 9 points that I've discussed, what I'm saying in the next slide, actually this is what is going to happen if we do all that. a big expenditure. So what I told you of now involves a lot of time and effort. So one thing is, of course, we have to do the work, but we are actually going to sit and focus on all those things means, no, that is really not the way. So there is going to be a lot of big expenditure, minimal results, and probably less or no business. So all that at the back of the mind, let it be there, but that is not really how we can go and get business. Instead, can we think of what is our strategy? What is the way we present ourselves? This I will like Guru to take it.
So, whatever she told all this time, many of us tend to do the same mistake.
Trying to go and get a website done, trying to go and get a business collateral, trying to do a PPT. And we expect that business will come because of this. But the unfortunate thing what is happening is, everybody is doing the same thing. If I have a website, and Vinod can go and have his own website. Anybody sitting here can have their own website. So where is the differentiator? And how many times of us have we actually gone to our website? None of us have gone. I have not seen my website for a long, long time. So any of these traditional ways of work would not lead us anywhere. Doing business collaterals, doing PPTs, fancy visiting cards, nice offers, office collaterals, this will only bleed our mind. And by the time you develop one more new technology has come and you are jumping next. There is no end for this. So we will have to think, how do we still go ahead and be noticed by the world? Be within the purview of love. Be within the code of conduct, not spend money, develop business, develop profession, and get into an organization culture. So doing an advertising through a website is almost a blasphemy today. Going to a social media, everybody is in social media. Everybody is in Facebook, everybody is in Twitter. And if you go and send a newsletter to any of your clients, Sri was telling me, send a newsletter. You go and send a newsletter to any of your clients, I spoke to one of the CFO. I told, sir, I sent a budget newsletter. Did you read? He told, yeah, very nice. I told, I had written an article in the third page about succession. But I didn't read that. Then I could make out he had not read. Like, please tell me what is the actual fact. Have you actually opened my book? He opened his inbox and showed me at least 30 newsletters. Today, anybody with a little bit of Word knowledge and Excel knowledge and convert it to a PDF and mail, anybody can. Today, I don't read any newsletters. There is too much of sensory overload today. Because people don't have time. She was referring about networking. How often we go back and tell a client, just I would like to meet you, catch up with you, have a cup of coffee, let's discuss something. They tell, Baba, leave me alone. Please don't send me WhatsApp updates. Please don't send me any updates. I'm fed up of updates. Please leave me alone. So as far as possible, if you can leave the client alone, life is easy. It's something like pampering your son. 24 hours sit with him, he'll become a dullard. Leave him, he'll come back to you at the end of the day. He says, you see your son only. So any of the strategies will only kill us, will not give us anything. And if I have a website, a PwC can have a website which is 200 times better than mine. I could never compete that way. It's never going to work that way. So we'll have to understand what's our strategy. Before we start practice, it is very simple for us to go and tell, Yahud Bharatva Della Tavaldi. Whatever work comes, I take all my work. So we sat down in 2003 and we had a lot of work till 2009. And we appointed a coach from IIM Bangalore and he gave us one stupid advice. One of the most stupid advice. He told, can you make a list of all your clients? We made a list of all the clients. In this, how many are individuals? How many are partnership firms? How many are HUF? How many are private limited companies? We made a beautiful list, gave it to him. Then he told, if you really believe me, can you surrender all your individual and partnership firms? He must be a pretty clown. I'm paying him 4 lakh rupees for advising me. And this clown is coming and telling, why don't you surrender all these files? Then he made a lot of sense. The amount of profitability we were making in a file was going down the more smaller the ticket size was. A person will come for a return, he has got a statement of affairs, a house property income, a capital gains income, and possibly the salary income. The maximum he is going to pay me is 2500 rupees. If I am very, very pricey and nice, he may pay me 5000 rupees. And if I position myself well, he can pay me 10,000. Out of 10,000, my profit margins are 4,000 rupees, not more than 40. And most of these clients pay me money when the next year returns come. They are not going to pay me money today. But can I flip it the other way around? Can I get money even before I do the job? I would need to look at a claim where I paid. If you are going to book my show, first they will pay your money. Then you come and watch the movie. They are not going to tell you, watch the movie, go eat popcorn, after some time you come back and then you can do this. That's not going to work. So we will have to establish ourselves what is our strategy. Where is it I am going to place myself as? This would be a very large question to answer. I will park this question for a couple of minutes. We will visit practice, and once we go through around 5-6 chapters, we will visit practice. This will possibly help you to frame exactly where we have to go. Just to give you an articulation, when we surrendered all the individual HUF files, people mocked at us. I had a family to support, I had a son, I had a car loan. They mocked at us. 3 years we suffered. But after 3 years, I really enjoyed what we had done. So we will have to have a lot of courage to implement a strategy. So what is required at a courage at this level is, can I tell no? I have got 8 claims, one client is not treating me with respect. Can I just knock off these 2 claims and manage with the 6? One client is eating away 80% of my time. I am running behind him. Half the time that fellow doesn't keep bills. Other half the time he will not give me information for scrutiny. Then when I go to scrutiny, the officer spits at me and I go back to this client. I get spit at the client also. And for getting so much spitting, he did do child accountancy. I could have become a broker. Why did he do child accountancy for all this? So let us have, whenever we do a strategy, we have to be prepared to lose. Unless you empty yourself, you can't fill it up with more. You can't come with a strategist telling that, okay, what all is here, I'll take care of it. I have my junior partner, I'll ask him to do the new business. I'll ask him to start a new vertical. That won't work. We have to take a call as a firm or something. So in this thing, we have to work on this minor notion. This is your song.
We were talking of an organization structure. What is required in an organization structure is transparency in an organization. What do we mean by transparency in an organization? Which is what I told you. When someone joins us, what is their growth path? How do they actually grow in the organization? How do they transform or transition into heading the teams? Today our profession has become very compliance driven. What do we mean by compliance driven? You have to file the same forms in a month, you have some 20 things to do, and it's not just your tax compliances. Today you have GST, Companies Act. So many compliances rule the roost today, and you are expecting a lot of people to do what I'm pressing.
No, I minimized it. I'm trying to access the Wi-Fi.
So, today, if we do not have a clear structure on how people are going to grow in the organization, it's quite a challenge for us to retain them. As we were coming to the institute, we were talking. 4 years back, we hired a bunch of BCom students. What we saw was the articles that we had hired, half the time were going on exam leave because every 6 months they're required to do some training, and that too, that mandatory training was making them, once 6 months they come in, then they again go on leave, then they again go on leave for another some NC, some training that they go through. And then after that, again final exam leave. And if you hire people who have not passed their intermediate, then for passing their intermediate only, the whole 3 years will go. So this is becoming quite a challenge for us in continuing the audits. And today when somebody is handling it, the same people are handling the work, it is easier for us to continue. Our profitability will be good. We don't have to worry about hiring more people or putting new people to make them understand the whole work. So when we were all sitting and brainstorming, we thought that we should have a lot more paid assistants in the firm. So we did. That is when we got into going into colleges and hiring people from BCom. So even your BCom will come at 10, 12, 15,000 you pay, and then make them some bit of a variable component which you can have. And these BCom kids will probably stay with you for about 3 years. And it is good for you if they are with you for 3 years. You don't want them to continue for long also, then they become really costly resources in the organization. So if they're there for 3 years, then you get their next line with you, and by the time that probably is after 3-4 years when he is quitting, the new person who is going to come is going to take over the work. That way we thought this BCom is going to be a right fit. So when we were coming, we were discussing, okay, this kid who joined us 4 years back is a fabulous worker. When he started at 12,000. Today he is earning some 44,000. But they have lot of good avenues in the industry where they can grow further. And today there is so much of compliances that they are doing. How much can you ask them to do your GST audit? How much can you ask them to sit and fill your GST forms? That is quite a pain. So in that sense, we have to give them a lot of avenues where they can grow. So maybe make them head of client or make them take some trainings in the organization and give them a growth path. So I have a leadership matrix which tells when they start, how do they start, and then when they graduate, next member, next level, how they can grow. Some bit of a transparency that way they can have, and they will know when they can actually really head a team and when they can create a really sizable team and then go to the next level. So that is what we mean by transparency in organization. Increment based on performance. Today, increment has to be based on performance. So I joined Guru and Jana in 2012. When I joined Guru and Jana, the salary that I was drawing was 70,000 rupees. And when I joined the firm, they told me they'll take me at the same salary. I actually fought for 2 weeks with Guru and I asked him, no, 70,000 you cannot give me. You have to give at least 10% hike. 10% hike is the industry standards at least. Please give me 10% hike. He said, no, don't worry about 10% hike. We will give you a profit share. I said, no, I don't want profit share. You give me 10% hike. So I was back then so innocent that I told, give me a hike. I don't want a profit share. But today I really understand. And what we have done is when we fix the salaries itself, we give them certain criteria where they achieve some bit of turnover, or you give them some, they do this quality reports. Some criteria which will actually give them an incentive to earn a little more than their fixed pay, and then this is also a way where we can regain people. Instead of a retention bonus, you call it a variable pay, or you call it an annual anniversary bonus. So however you want, you can term this, but that is a way where people are going to look forward to have something more. Increment based on performance is going to be a very important factor. Now when I say performance, performance is dependent on each organization's policies and culture that you are going to follow. So you have to sit and brainstorm for yourself what is this performance criteria that will hold good for your organization. And you have to define those parameters. Succession planning. Now within the firm, do we have how we are going to introduce new people into the team? Now today we are 13 partners. But then if we are calling your 13 partners, some of the partners are seniors, then some of us in the mid-level, and some of them a bit younger. And what we saw it was important for us to have our second line ready. And now second line ready is, we call them the practice leaders. That is just some label which we coined. Not like managers, not like a deputy director, not like a director, which is the common terminology. We came up with a word called a practice leader, who actually is a leader, but he is practicing to be a leader. So we said practice leader can be a good term which we can use. So now we are actually training within our team. So if I had the corporate governance team, I already have a practice leader under me. So tomorrow if I want to venture out into something else, or I want to grow the team a little more bigger, or I want to make his own clients that he is handling as a separate vertical, so he can take care of that. And now in the partnership firm, 13 years and no partners reduced. So which means we have kept adding on the partners, and that has been good. How is it that we can retain the partners is a very, very important factor. Then partnership firms break. The partnership firms break mainly because people want something else out of each other. So if our visions are not aligned, if all of us do not think that the firm is above us, or if only one of them is thinking he is actually bringing in all the business while the other partners are not doing anything. So all the other partners are thinking, I'm the only one who is working so hard, he's only just going and marketing. So that way it can be a challenge. We have to define clearly what each of the partners' roles are. So it is going to help us. Now when I talk of the verticals within the organization also, there are admin activities, there are HR activities, there are tech activities. Then there is a Mahatriya Foundation that we all do. So the foundation activities. So that way each partner, apart from being responsible for their own function, can be responsible for the soft skills functions of the organization. So that also you define. That also tech, we can tell one of the partners will handle. One person has to take care of this whole initiative. One person has to take care of getting people into the organization. One person has to take care of making sure that he gets clients. So this way you can bifurcate. And my share is not big. So how it all started, when we started our practice, we were the only people who were getting all the revenues, who were doing all the work. So when I started, I used to earn a 10 lakh of rupees, where my share of profit was 100%. Then as we went by, then it became 20 lakhs. My share get reduced, like from 100 it became about 45, but I was at that time earning 20 lakhs of rupees. Then it became 40, which is about 50 lakhs, and then it only became 20, which is actually 5 crores today. Which means, we should not keep the entire profit for ourselves. Instead, we should look at making the size of the pie bigger. How do we go ahead to reduce our profit share, in which way we can get more people into the team and more people can share the profits? So it should not be that we should hold everything for ourselves, but in absolute numbers, our profits, the earnings that we all do, should keep growing. That is how success can be.
I'll just break for a second, Stan, to give a little more clarity on this thought. See, in many enterprises, when you look at a private limited company or anything, the company is owned by a bunch of individuals. In our profession, in most cases, it is structured as a partnership firm, and the partners are the owners of the partnership firms. Across the spectrum, there are three or four models. The first model is where you tell he is only a partner for namesake. So the name is given as a partner, he will get 1% share of profit, but he will get a salary plus he will get an incentive. That is model one. The second model will be a situation whereby I will take him as a minor partner, say 4% or 6% or 8%, then all the senior partners will reduce to 2% of their share. So the expectation is this gentleman in the next 30 years or 40 years slowly will step 2%, 4% and finally reach some 28%. Now look at a situation like this. If it is a partnership firm whereby one person joins at 8 lakh of rupees, that X will do all the work and the senior partner will take around 20 lakh of rupees and go out. This will survive for some time. 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, 4 years. After one day, that definitely is going to break because of 3 reasons. One, the client already knows that partner. The client knows that the senior partner is not doing any work. Only this guy is doing all the work. Two, that younger partner also knows very clearly that he is doing all the work, he is retaining only a small portion, the lion's share is going to the founder partner. Three, he has never felt a owner. Just by giving him a name in the partnership deed, that does not make him a owner. Even though he is not a owner, in case he can take the calls as a partner, then only he becomes a owner. So when you enter into a partnership deed, this point has to be extremely well articulated. For example, we have a share in the profits determined in the partnership deed. We have a common practice today. Ramesh will earn 20%. Vinod will earn 30%. Suraj will earn 40%. Matter is over. 100% is divided and taken care of. But what will happen? How will Ramesh from 20 move to 40? Is his performance never rewarded, or is it over a passage of time? Traditionally, when we look at any CA firm, I have to be patient. But my friends, today it is not the world of patience, it's a world of performance. I am doing the work, I am getting clientele, I am hardworking, I am understanding the latest technology, I am getting in transfer pricing, I know all the officers. Everything is what I know. Then why is it I am not able to earn as much as this? No, in my days I worked so hard. That is your days. You work so hard in your days. So when we structure a partnership deed, what would be required is, as far as possible, don't define share of profits. Understand fully from the income tax point of view, you have to define share of profits. Fully recognize that fact from the point of view of the act, you define. From the point of view of the act, remuneration under 40 has to be defined, you define remuneration. But having said that, rewards need not be exactly as per the income tax act. Whether you have a say in the equity or are you having a say only in your earnings makes a difference. For example, if you take an employee and the employee is getting a salary of 8 lakhs and I give him an incentive of 3 lakhs, he is getting 11 lakhs. At the same time, if I take a partner and if the partner is earning 20 lakhs and he will give him an additional share of profit of 2% and making 24 lakhs, except the number, there is no difference between the employee and the partner. Both are exactly the same. Then how are you calling in a partner? It is extremely vital to understand what is the definition of the partner when we do this. What she meant by that fact is, let us concentrate on growing the firm. If the firm grows, everybody will benefit. If I concentrate on my share, even my share goes down, even that person goes. If you look at the first fourth slide I had put in, the fourth slide was talking about what are the number of partnership firms. We were going back and analyzing one more theory in the institute, and we took out a lot of data and we broke out the data. Only in the city of Bangalore, whenever a firm is reconstituted, you need to file a particular form with the Institute of Chartered Accountants. Only in the city of Bangalore, we have totally put together in practice only around 6,500 firms, people. In 6,500 people, if you look at the industry metrics of the CA Institute, you are looking at a metrics of around 1,500 people being in partnership firms, around 3,500 people being in proprietary entity. Only for the 1,500 firms, in the last 1 year, totally 350 times reconstitution has happened. That means 1 out of 4 firms there is a reconstitution. So data definitely tells something that we are doing wrong. Every reconstitution is not only for an admission. If it was an admission, the number of people who are in the partnership firms would have become more. But in the last 5 years, it has become less. Number of firms joining in partnership firms have become lesser than the number of firms breaking the partnership firms. So when she meant in that slide that 13 years no partner reduced this, the whole concept telling that, can I really define the ownership in my partnership deed? What do I define as a ownership? Suppose in an organization, we take a partnership deed and tell all the profits has to come on to one individual. One individual will have to be in the helm of affairs. He is very scared of the client control. All the clients are with him. Final client meetings only he goes. For fixing the details in the income tax department, only he goes. Other details cannot be fixed by other people. That other person will move out. So we will have to create a structure which is based on the pillar of what is the sense of equity. Second pillar is it being fair? So try to create a partnership deed which is very dynamic. So a partnership deed which can be designed is like this. Define the partnership ratios. End of the year, rework on that. Sit down on the MIS profits, which are the real profits of the organization. Find out what is each person's contribution in it as transparent manner. We do it for every client. We are sitting and analyzing cost center report for claims. For every client, we are sitting and giving cost center balance sheets. We talk about SBU analysis when we go for internal audit. We tell this branch has performed well, this branch has not performed well. We are doing it everything for the outside world. Similarly, can be defined in a partnership firm itself. As on 31st, we relook at that. It's a matter of just redefining the partnership deed as at 31st of March. Redefine the partnership deed, make a dynamic partnership deed. Rework on the profits and the firm will stay as long as possible. And second, when she means by my share is not big, we'll have to look at two shares. One share is the profits we earn from the firm. And the second share is what is the equity we have in the value of the firm. Now, none of us value an equity in the firm because there is nothing called we sell my firm, I'll hand it over to somebody, we'll merge with somebody. That sense of equity is not there. We all do valuation exercises. We do valuations for small firms than ours. The firm is so small, we are sitting and doing valuation for them. But we don't do anything for our firms only. So if you can have the two principles there where we measure exactly for each of your partnership deeds as to where we settle down the equity, that would be fantastic. Before I hand over to Shri, I'll tell you the third statistics. In South India, the institute has given the list of members and all those things. In the last 3 years, just only in South India region, that is comprising of Karnataka, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana right now, and only in the South India region, the firms which has closed down in the last 3 years has been 700 firms. 700 firms have been closed down in the last 3 years. That means It is a firm where an individual has been a partner, he has held on till the end, and then he has left, the firm is collapsed. The four people, employees are there, they'll take this much file, claims will move out somewhere. That statistic should give us something that we are doing something wrong. The firm, to build a firm, it will take you 25, 30 years. I'm now 52, 53. If I have to move out of the firm by 62, 63, somebody has to be there to take over the firm. Now, all of us are sitting here, the people who are around 45, 50, 60. At the age of 50, if you can look at something, tell that, okay, in the next 10 years, I need to move out. So what am I going to do? Will I be slogging till the end? And already we are all bunked up, because in the tax audit season, none of us can sit till 2 o'clock in the night. We are already bunked up. So with this, I'll give it back to her. She can take it further from there.
Sir, sorry. Can you drive the discussion on more specific strategies like how to strategies to grow tax practice, how to strategies to grow audit practice?
I think we should do that, sir, because we are doing too slow. We'll rush very fast.
Please be more specific on...
I'm sorry. I understand your point. Maybe these slides will jump fast. The last 20 slides will tell you how to get business. That would be more interesting. We'll move fast. I fully understand you.
We already told this, so let the organization structure be very transparent and driven, so that people will not have to worry about sticking on who is getting business and what can be done. I think open office has something which has caught up. So gone are the days when people used to have cabins and people used to walk into the boss's cabin. Today, having an open office structure is a very transparent structure, and actually people really appreciate that, where you are not having hierarchy as a partner's chair, as a boss's chair. Those things can be planned. And organization structure, what we are saying here is a traditional structure. There is a partner who is heading with managers and some executives, and this can be across all teams that are there. Instead, can we think this when we think of hiring resources? Can we think whether somebody who is in the organization is either a long-term or a short-term resource? He's either a transaction or somebody who is going to stay with us long-term. When we know some person is going to stay with us long-term, we can think of actually working with him to grow him, to make him to be a partner. Are we going to pamper them or create them in the sense when some people join us, is it that they have to actually be... You have to study each person and find out what suits, what style of leadership is for that person and go ahead with that. Is someone a thinker or a doer? So we need thinkers also, we need doers also in the organization. And based on what each one is good at, we can think and do that. And loyalist and an opportunist. So people are here only as a stepping stone for them to grow into industry or join bigger consulting firms or join MNCs. So that way, are they going to stick with us or are they going to move on? We can think and grow the chart for them. Then here, the speed of the engine is determined by the speed of the train, which means how fast we can all carry everyone along with us is how fast we can grow the organization. So if only one person in the organization is growing really fast, then it might not really help for all of us to grow together. So we should make sure to work with everyone, and that way give them each one a role and make them feel important. Do you want to take this?
We want the strategies faster. We're wasting too much time.
So the leadership matrix, what we are saying is when we can have different levels within the organization, can we identify how they become from one level to another level? So you can probably think of framing a simple policy, which is a one-pager or a two-pager policy, which will give people an idea how long they are going to become, once they become a member to an, once they are an article to a chartered accountant, or once they have finish 3 years in the firm, where they are going to grow into. Then for the next 3 to 5 years, what are the skill sets one has to develop within themselves so that they can grow to the next level? That way, can we define a lot of them? Here we have said personality traits, then there can be certain firm values, then there are certain professional values, then knowledge oriented, so knowledge is a very critical aspect, then certain key aspects of the firm, and something that can be unique. So that way a leadership matrix, you can only decide on and frame it and how each one can understand and what is the growth. So here nobody is actually getting into politics, nobody thinks that the other person was promoted and they were not promoted. So there can be a clearly defined strategy and a clearly defined policy for anybody who wants to be within the firm itself. So legal and veto structure plays a very important role. So I already told having everything in black and white is going to be a critical aspect. So all decisions have to be made and each one has to agree to disagree. So the thing is, without having ego amongst all of us, we need to make sure that there is equal rights amongst the partners. Of course, it's very theoretical for me to say that. In all this, then some of us will feel superior, some of them are really equal, some of us will all work together as very good friends. All that is there. But there has to be one super boss, there has to be one really, a person who owns the leadership and who actually, whom we all go to. So there is always this one person who we go to. That probably could be each one of you sitting here. When any crisis in the organization, they'll come and think of you. That person is something whom we can call, who has the super majority rights, who has the veto power in deciding a lot of things. What are the important aspects which we should make sure is written down and one person has the casting vote is these. When that it has to be a merger or a demerger or networking, if we have to join a part of a network. Create a subsidiary or another company. We want to start another branch in some other city, then make sure all of us concur to do it and we don't do it in silos. If other partner wants to be removed, so sometimes there might be a situation where all of them have to be joining together to remove a certain partner. But then make sure that one person has the casting vote. To admit a new partner, to create a new team, to permit a partner to start anything individually in the profession. So one partner wants to teach besides being in the profession, then can that other person do devote his time? Another partner wants to start a hotel, decide, all of you decide and then agree towards it. Merger, demerger already done. Then, so what we are saying here is, one was a veto structure, the another thing what we are saying is, when we all draw profits, are we all drawing all the monies once a profit comes, or are we keeping aside some money for growth initiatives of the organization? Now growth initiatives I would mean is taking over some people or taking over an audit firm or starting a branch somewhere else or hiring a senior resource into the organization. These type of things, are we thinking growth initiatives and can we keep aside some money that we can afford to and keep it as a piggy bank that we can actually go and dip into it anytime and get that money to think of a growth initiative. That way we are saying, have a firm share also. Kahoot.it.
I agree with your thought fully well.
That how we have done the presentation is first 4 or 5 slides or chapters may look very theoretical. I don't disagree with you. But unless you implement this, you can't go to the next level. You are talking of a business strategy of getting more business. There are many things where I can get hundreds of more business. There is no doubt about it. But if you don't even have a foundation, what will you do by getting more business? You can't even solve that. Suppose you get an audit of a 100 crore company, there is no way you can do with a smaller organization setup. So the entire thing has been structured, so the last has been kept for how do we get more work? How would I raise my ratings? How will I be able to get different type of work? What are the new areas of work? And we have tried to keep it that way. So as I told, we will just try to do an introspection exercise of whatever we did. You don't have to think it's just like a game, small sort of a tool. If all of you can access Kahoot.it, so you should access Kahoot.com. No, you went into IT. Kahoot.it. If it doesn't work, internet is too slow, I hope it works. So we have made some few questions, approximately 13 or 14 questions. Oh, it's too slow. I've tried to access it through my Wi-Fi. Sir, so Wi-Fi it was installed in it. My Wi-Fi too much slow it. Mangaldas, we took Padam sir's opinion, almost a 30-page document. I would be more than happy to share it. You can have a look at it, because that structured it so well that a firm cannot stop progress. It is a dynamic partnership deal. It's not just the name clause and your profit sharing clause that anybody can create. That's the job of a chartered accountant to create. So you logged in? No, now you have to go to? Okay. You guys have been able to access Kahoot? Yeah, the pin will come once this opens up, right? I'll try to do it on my mobile. I'll do it. You can try here. Maybe the mobile will be faster. Even I have the same 4G. We did it in office, it worked very well. Access Institute Peps have I taken? From the Institute only.
Okay.
Sir, so, I'll break for tea break and then we'll continue. Perfectly, okay, that should be fine. Yeah. Sir, in case we are going slow on any of this thing, very happy if you could interfere, we'll jump faster. Because when we get carried away in doing this, it may not be relevant at the end. Please keep asking questions, we'll jump faster to the next slides. So, we'll take a break. Sir, how long, sir?
After the nice jalebis and provide this, let us put it out, and somebody wanted to have the email ID at the end of the day. I'll put in some email IDs, and to be frank with you, we would have enough of material to share. In case you require at any point of time, just please send a mail, we'll be happy to share. Because at the end of the day, the profession has to work, it is not the form. For example, you want a partnership deed, and as we progress down, you need a succession planning document. You need to make a partner document. Or can be as trivial as, I don't have a proposal for a system study. I don't have a proposal for IBC. Whatever you require, please don't hesitate, because we are a small bird. We are not a large bird. We are all put together, not even 1,000 people who come to the institute. I'll be happy to share. At the same time, I'll also request you to share whatever you have. Just send a mail to us. We'll be more than happy to share. So you just access this kahoot.in, that's classic. So you get a small number, you type in this number. What we did for the last 45 minutes, we'll try to just recapitulate it through an interview. This is the number is 1049337. 1049337. And once you get it, you will be asked a nickname. You can either give you a short name, Guru, or you can, if you don't want to give your name, you can just write XYZ or whatever. And in the left, one person, Ram, has joined. So a lot of people, 11 people joined. 15, 21, 25, 29, 30, 31. People are going in. We have around 100 odd. At least if 60 can join, we can get in. 34. Somebody has given a D, POM. POM is a name. Somebody has given POM. 44. So how it happens is, whatever you come across in your mind, try to do it fast. The idea is, whoever does it fastest would get the higher marks. And all are very, very simple questions. Nothing of complexities. Very simple questions. There would be three colors. One is green, one is red, one is amber. If you feel the answer to the question is right, you press green. If you feel the answer to the question is wrong, you press red. If you feel that you don't know, you can press amber. So this is just a recapitulation exercise to know where we are. We have around 4-5 of this. It takes 2.5-3 minutes to run through this. So you can start. You have 54. Start. There are 16 questions. Each question is around 10 seconds, 20 seconds. Should not take more. Is area of work clearly identified in your partnership deed? Partner A will handle audit, partner B will do claim control, partner C will handle HR, partner D will handle taxation. Is this defined? Yes or no? Yes. You can press
Sorry, yes is red color, no is blue color. Yes is red color. When I did it in the office, it was a different color. 27 of them tell yes and 20 of them tell no. Next day. From 9:53, she has been the fastest, Tom has been the fastest. Is veto control established in IT? What is a veto control? I can't sell the firm without asking Guru. I can't buy a firm without asking Guru. One example. Is veto control well defined in your thing? Yes is red, no is blue. There is 2, 4, 3, 2, 1 second. Done. 37 defined no, so that at least it would be an indication. Go back and get your veto controls right there. Next. Nishchal is 1875. Form has gone down. Next. 3 of 16. Is my profit share fixed for life or is it dynamic? What I mean by this is, do you have a share where you revisit the share once in 2 years? Once in 3 years? Revisit the share as often as possible. Yes is red, no is blue. Vinod, nahi mil raha
hai
aapko? Next question you can join me. 33 yes, 33 no, perfect. Then next. So Nishchal is doing very well. We are a firm where each partner has his own claims, own employees. That means we are a firm where there are 4 partners. The partner will handle all his claims, his own employees. So we are almost like a polyclinic. Yes or no? And in your mind, think, is that the right way to structure? Is it that I have to handle only my claims? He handles his own claims, the third partner handles his claims. We are not specializing, we are not together as a firm. We are together only in building. 40 no. Next. Really, what would you like to see? Who is that mission? Next one. We are not a firm who are only on a cost sharing basis. There are firms who just share costs. Revenue is separate. That is not a partnership firm at all. It is a polyclinic where you just come in and join hands and you try to do work together. So retrospect whether this is applicable to your firm. Yes is red, no is blue. 39 and 30. Not bad, we have now got 69 people. See something. Next. Next. 6 of 16. We have defined our firm values. What I mean by defined is there a document which shows your firm values? We will not pay a bribe, is a value. We are not going to accept claim humiliating us, is a value. Have we defined this? In fact, in most firms, in our firm, the firm value is in the partnership deed. These are the values. If a partner breaks the values, you are out of the firm. 39, 30. Next. Seven of 16. Our firm is bigger than its founders. Is a firm based only on the founder? That means, is it my firm or is it our firm? Our firm is bigger than the founder. Yes, the firm is bigger than the founder. Red. No, the firm is not bigger. The founder is bigger. Is no. Blue. Beautiful, beautiful. 56 is positive. We have treated all our partners exactly as equals. The money you take may be different, but the treatment is equal in terms of rights, in terms of responsibilities, in terms of duties. All citizens are equal. Similarly, are all partners equal? You may be having different competencies, but at the end of the day, if you are a partnership firm, are we all equal? Do we have a bigger cabin than the other partners? Only I get to travel in business, the others don't. Next. Oh. Do we realize the firm gets claims and I am not getting claims? The fact is the claims come because of the firm, not because of the individual. So do I realize, I am only getting claims to Guru Arjan? Absolutely wrong. The firm gets the claims. I am just instrumental in this. Nishchal is touching 10,000 bucks. Who is Nishchal, by the way? Who is here? Okay. Firm is represented by your sincere employees and not my family members. My family members don't have a say in the firm as much as my employees. My wife really gets upset at me. If I come for a puja, you make me stand back. No, you have to stand back. You are not the firm. My employees are the firm. 11 of 16. When there is a puja or a function, my sincere employees are not in the forefront. Only my family is in the forefront. So is it a family organization or is it an organization? If your family is in the forefront, no. If the employees are in the forefront, yes. Next. Do I look fair and just as a senior partner? If I am heading the firm, I have to be appear to be right and I also to be right. I should be right and also appear to be right. Do I look fair? If any of the senior partners are here, you can mark it. Do you really look fair or you really don't look fair? Next. 13 of 16. Have I got time to spend with my partners outside office? Relationships are made not only in a conference room. Relationships are made when you go home. Have I got time to take it out? Have I met my partners outside their office? How many of us know their family problems? How many of them know their lives? Have I got it, yes or no? Next. 14 of 16, number of answers are coming down. Is there an issue on sharing of money? Have we openly admitted that? Something happened. Is there an issue of sharing of money and have you openly discussed? I don't think you are getting more, you are getting less. I am working hard, I am not getting more, you are getting more. Have you openly discussed? Is this in the partner's minutes book? Is it documented? Yes? No? 15 of 16, one more to go. Have I got a mindset to quit this firm at any time? I don't want to be in this firm. Do I have a mindset like this? If I have a mindset, problematic. If I don't have a mindset, very good. Do I have a mindset to go here? 27, have a mindset to go. Look, guys, all these 27, please come to our firm. We are looking forward for good people. Next. 16. I am a junior partner. I am looking forward in this firm. I know this is my right place. I joined the right place. Are you able to tell it with conviction today? I have joined the right place. I am happy being here. I am going to stay here till the end of my career. Lovely. 50 of them, yes. 13 of them, guruanjana.com, please do come. So, who's KNR? That's been lovely. KNR, Suhas has got 13,000, is there. All the youngsters are doing routing world. And first is, Nishal has got one, that's wonderful. Thank you so much. And this is a short thing so that we could recapitulate exactly what we were going through. Can we move to the next list? Is it yours or mine? Mine. See, what it's very important in order to attract claims is an organization character. You cannot get claims without an organization character. And all of us may think, okay, what is the meaning of an organization character? Why is it organization required to have a character? And it is defined, if you give an example, if you look at Tata's, if there is an apartment constructed by Tata's and somebody else has X, as a layman, you prefer to go to Tata's because there is an element of trust. If a multinational company is coming to India, as an option, the multinational company would like to go to the Big Four. Saying, look, I already know Big Four are all over the world. They are also in India. I would like to go there. So that is a character defined by a multinational company. So similarly, do we have a character defined? And character drives the, culture drives the organization character. Good option. See, just to give a simple example, we have some three pillars called happy organization, speed in service, respect all time and wish. These are standard metrics any person with a common sense can notice. But what is very important here is, how do I tie it up to the firm? I'll give you some examples. Suppose if it is a happy organization. What do you mean by a happy organization? Employees are happy. How do you make them happy? You can't take them to pizzas every day. Employees never get happy by eating pizzas. So can I bring in a technology to take it there? Can I get a technology to enable this? When she is going to take it up, she is going to tell what is the technology which can help the employee become happy. One example I can tell you is, in any establishment, you should not be the one who is giving the increment. The moment you are giving the increment, it has become, of course, you are the decision-making partner. There is no doubt about it. You take a decision, it's your firm. But the moment you are giving something, you are on the above and somebody else is on the below. So is there a technology tool which you can build where the increment is measured, the employee knows, these are my jobs I have done. I have done 5 tax audits. I have done 7 GST audits. I have given 15 CA, 15 CB certificates. The total fees the firm has earned is this much. And if I just put it in a matrix, the employee knows exactly what is the profit the firm has earned because of it. Similarly, we also know. Infrastructure. A simple example could be, can we all have photographs of our employees in the office? It's a very, very tiny example. Suppose you, all of you are using Gmail. Gmail has got an option where guru@gurujana.com is Gmail. Whosoever birthday is there, we put their photo in the login page of Gmail. So the moment you go to type gmail.com, you have a place where you can put logo. Instead of that logo, just put the employee's photo. Infrastructure is happy around it. Has to be enough of HR engagements. Sri will take you through that. Today, no employee is happy just by getting increments. Every employee is happy if you challenge them. But how do we challenge them through an auditing process or a technology income tax process is very, very important. Get an assessment of this 143.2 without a single flaw. Push it up. Now that is the challenge. And client acquisition will have to happen purely based on the character of the firm. I am not exaggerating this when we tell the character of the firm can pull in clients. Now, for example, if you are a firm who can only concentrate on startups, client will gravitate towards you. You are an organization who has a character of only doing work on CSR. Both corporate CSR and the domestic CSR or the CSR implementation. Those clients will automatically get attracted to you. So an organization character would be very, very vital. The three are only simple examples. There is a document which most of the MNC firms have, which is defined as an organization culture document. Juniper has got it. Infosys has got a document. Infosys has got it in its website itself. In case you need to have a document of a chartered accountancy office, I'll be happy to share it with you. What is an organization culture document? We don't fancy preparing large documents. It will be a simple checklist like what we played in Kahoot. Yes, no checklist. We'll be happy to share it with you. We have another 25 minutes, sir. We have another 1 hour. So this may take around 15-20 minutes. So when we started, see, this is not a discussion. By the way, we have 13 partners, out of that 4 are girls. With due respects to the pretty women sitting here, to manage the 4 is very, very difficult, including this one. It is not very easy to have 13 partners with 13 idiosyncrasies, 13 ambitions and 13 different things. On top of it, women are very difficult to manage. It's not easy at all.
Emotions.
Because we go and tell, we push on something. Hey, come on, let us go and finish this. The employee has to stay till 12 in the night. I don't care. She comes back and tells, don't you think they have family? Is this the way you run an organization? For everything, there is issue. So it does become very difficult if you have women in the management team. Even to look at, if you, the simple example I can give to CSR spend will increase by 5 times. Very employee engagement expenses will increase by 4 times. And the beauteous part is they will not allow anything wrong to happen. They will not touch a claim which is going to create problems for you. Nam yaka paitu. We guys are aggressive guys, we will do a lot of things. And especially in income tax scrutiny and all, it really, really helps a lot. Really helps a lot. So what is very important is, as a firm, what am I segmented and positioned? See, thought, I'll give you some thoughts, around 8 or 10 thoughts. You can see where are you fitting in. I specialize only in taxation. Is one segment I have created for myself. I specialize in service taxes. Those, when I prepared this, I just put it as service taxes. They should have put it as GST. Or we only do work on IFRS. Or we have a business consulting job. Now let us take a step back. All of us have done work for so many startups. Every startup has a focus. This is the target segment I am going to attack. I am not going to take everybody else. Swiggy. is a company which only targets millennials. Flipkart will not target me because they know I will not buy in Flipkart. Flipkart will only target her. Book My Show will not come to me. But Merrill Lynch will contact me. Mutual fund companies will contact me. So we are subject to segmentation at every stage, but why not we have a segmentation in our profession? Having said that, how many of us sitting here will have to make a very clear strategy, I want to go only in this direction? We are advisors to thousands of companies, but seldom our own company. A doctor does not walk. A chartered accountant does not maintain proper accounts. We are the ones who file our returns last. We take care of everybody, then we come to our returns.
Sir, but your credit is to your firm, you file on the
first. We file on first, sir. We file on first because we declare profits on first. We file on first, we take out profits on first. So, if you look at the thing, how we will have to take a little time to position, where are we going to concentrate? When you go to the next slide, when we started a little work, I was speaking to some of the partners. I read a book called Methods Method. It is a US-based book. I'll talk about this book later. As a chartered accountancy firm, I realized that I would not like to do work with partnerships and private smaller companies, because not for that they are wrong, because I don't get revenue. I'm not getting profitability. I am a chartered accountant, and if I don't understand profitability, who's going to understand profitability? I am not getting share of profit on this. Plus, there are a lot of wrong things happening. He will have three SB accounts in that fellow, one SB account he will not show it to me. Only two SB accounts he will show it to me, and I have to prepare a competition statement based on that. So we don't, let us not touch the opening balance account. Let us not look the small things. But then what will happen to the large corporates? The entire large corporates are not with us. Now if I go and I want to pitch in for Siemens, even with a 400 people organization, I am finding it very difficult. They are only giving me a GST refund work. They are not giving me quality work. So why should I go and break my head and build competencies for the bottom of the pyramid and the top of the pyramid? Can I build competencies only in the middle? So we told, let us only concentrate on, take a hypothetical situation, all of us sitting here will concentrate on SME firms. Now SME firms are very large. How do I categorize thousands of SME firms around there? I can't go around every SME firm and do it. So as an example, I can suggest that let us not between this group decide that we will not take a client who has got a bank overdraft of 1 crore. Why would I do that? I don't want to take a client with a bank overdraft of 1 crore because he will come back for me telling that, sir, stock adjustment maadkodi. Neevu swalpa jaasti maadi. Nan drawing power kammi aagide. Why would I break my head in something? So get them out. I will not enter a company which has got trading. Why I don't want to enter into a company which has got trading? Trading will have purchases, they will have sales, they will have book entries, HR issues, and seldom books will be reconciled. How many of us get here clearly audited, pre-audited trial balancer? We get data where PR assembly is not done. We sit and do PR assembly. On the camera, I cannot tell that. If it grosses the camera, I don't. Post-audit JVs, at least we would have passed 50 JVs to 75 JVs. After we take, we sit and do GL review and we pass general entries. Then only we are able to prepare a Schedule 3, otherwise we can't prepare Schedule 3. And again we can't bill for a Schedule 3 because institute tells I have not prepared the financials. What crazy is this? My client doesn't even know how to do a BRS. You expect me to tell, okay, you place the accounts in the board of directors meeting, I'll come and then sit down and chat. One client I'll not. So again, remove those things because trading will again reduce everything of my profitability. I can't be working with trading companies. They will not maintain stock records. They will not give me confirmation of balance. And too much work for too little money.
And when they work with the Big Four, they give all the things.
Everything.
Yeah.
Your wife also will treat you the way you treat her. So everybody will treat you the way you treat her.
But we don't get such care.
So then again we iron out that and then concentrate, okay, where will I invest my competencies?
For that you have to go to Gurujan.
So we keep on reducing and told, okay, in this mid-segment I can only concentrate on three aspects. So we told, let us do one thing. We can have our own segments. We will concentrate only on startups which are funded. Segment 1. segment 2. We will not do any other work other than US, Singapore, Germany, UK coming to India. Only two segments. We will not do any other work. So can I focus all my energies in this one segment? So if it is a startup, what can I do for a startup? Startup are invested, so auditors are big four. So what can I do? Can I do accounting for them? Impossible. They're crazy. I can do MIS for them. I can do compliances. I can do GST. I can do corporate law. I can do tax audit. I can do GST audit. I can do systems verification. So instead of doing one trading company, which is a Bombay dyeing showroom, which pays me 80,000 rupees or a lakh of rupees tax audit, if I concentrate only on a startup ecosystem, I can almost build 9-10 lakhs per annum. So even if I can build one, two startups, and I'll tell you, how do we get startups? How do you get this business also, I'll tell you. I'm quite transparent on it, this is what we do also. I'll exactly tell you how to get ready. So even if I can concentrate on two startups, which can give me a revenue of around 20-25 lakhs, there would be a deal. That means there would be an acquisition or there would be a due diligence that could top up another 4-5 lakh of rupees billing. It's a steady income. Now similarly, if I target a US-based company coming to India, they require only one thing. They require stability. They are scared of compliances. So the definition we give there is, any US company coming to India is afraid of our law, so I should be a painkiller. If I am a painkiller for you, I am taken away with that. How do I be a painkiller? Instead of being in the back pencher, I will be on your board of directors. Please pay me director's fees. I am a professional director. I will be the officer in default. We are either way doing compliances for everybody. GST we are only fighting. TDS we are only fighting. PF we are only fighting. ESA we are only fighting. Then why am I scared to be a director simplicitor? Institute allows it.
But education, normally education makes you cowardice.
Education makes you cowardice.
Because you have the knowledge, you know that there is something can go
wrong. But that cowardice is never there when we plan for claims. We do every planning for claims. So if you go back to that segment, we again charter and go back and tell, I will not take a claim which is coming from China. Because the only thing straightforward with Chinese is their hair. Everything else is straight ahead. So I will not take a claim from China. I will take a claim from US, I will take a claim from UK, I will take a claim from Germany. Now how do I go to only these countries? So what I am trying to tell is, can we segment it? Can we go deep into the segment? I will only concentrate on all the jewelry shops in the country. Let me become a jewelry auditor. I will segment myself only to the jewelry. Let me become an investment advisory auditor. Only there I concentrate. So what is it we are doing in practice is, this would be the most important thing for us to do. Have I segmented myself correctly, or am I picking everything what I am getting? If I am picking up everything what I am getting, I will never get what I want. I will never ever get what I want. So from the day one when we surrendered 1800 trades, we told, let us segment ourselves. We will concentrate on deeper aspects. Now we are going into such a level of segmentation that I will only concentrate on work which is coming from San Francisco. Forget US, only coming from San Francisco, because word spreads there. San Francisco is such a small place. Palo Alto is so small. So if I have 4 claims in Palo Alto, getting another 30 in Palo Alto is no big deal. But if I am all over the world, I am all over. Can I tell no to it? We have to have something called as a claimant acceptance form. Only if we fill up the claimant acceptance form, if any of you want a copy of the claimant acceptance form, I will be happy to share with you. If you have a claimant acceptance form where you fill and all three partners sign, we take it. Look at the right side, that's a Leela Hotel. Look at the left side, it is a Hotel Suvidha. If I take a customer who sits in Hotel Suvidha, he will get me another claim from who is his neighboring Hotel Suvidha. I am building my practice only under that. So today we land up in a situation after 30 years of practice, what do you have? I have traders in Nagarpet, I have traders in Yashwantpur, I have traders in Mamalpet. Not that they are bad, they are wonderful, we are living because of them. But having said that, I don't have profitability there. Neither I have interest in doing that work. So if I go into that community, I get only that community. Have you observed it? You go to a contractor, he'll get you 3 more contractors. You go to a trader, he'll get you 3 more traders. You go to one black marketing fellow, you get to another 4 black marketing fellows. So your claim profile is only becoming better. So you need to profile your claims extremely carefully. Are these my claims? Can I say no to it? It is very vital for us to do, which is thought number two. Look at this P&L account. All of us know this very well. We are all masters of the P&L account. The entire profession is surviving on the fact whether I can make the tax 26% or between 26 to 33. 30% is my tax. The entire fraternity of chartered accountants, we are going ahead and telling you are 33 maximum, I can make it 25. There is no way I can go below 25. The law does not permit me to go below 25. Even if I am doing demonetization transaction, I can't go below 25. I am stuck there. So all of us are struggling telling that I will get you a tax assessment. We are playing around only in X. If you just flip around a little and help the client to increase his income from 1425 crores to 1450 crores. Just flip around a little. We are only doing tax compliance. All of us are stuck only in tax compliance, profit before tax, profit after tax. There is nothing beyond that we are doing, and we are the best finance professionals in the entire country. There is nobody else better than us. If we just shift ourselves a little into sales domain, okay, let me go into your sales segmentation. So we have seen firms, in especially in Bombay, Gujarat, in those sectors, where the firms are specializing in sales segmentation and sales analysis. They are going to GST portals and analyzing sales and giving back to them. And even if you can increase the claim, turnover from 1425 crores to 1450 crores, you have increased 25 crores, your fees can definitely go up from 10 lakhs to 20 lakhs. We will never be in a situation where we will go back and tell last year I did tax audit, you paid me 40,000, this year please pay me 50,000. Now we are not askers, we will have to be the givers. So even if you look at situations like COGS, indirect costs, we have specialized templates available in the market. How do I measure COGS? Let us take an example of all your claims. All our claims are having security services. All our claims are having courier services. All our claims are having internet services. Just take these three examples. Get one article claim. Ask him to sit down with the books of 100 claims. Prepare a columnar statement. Claim A, B, C, D. What is courier cost? What is the cost of transportation? What is the cost of security services? You can spin it off to 100 other things. You can spin it off to exchange gain. You can spin it off to exchange loss. You can spin it off to manpower ratio, rent per manpower. And just give it back to your claim. What a statement is done by an article student telling that, look, I have analyzed 100 claims. You are doing very bad in this area. Among 100 claims, you are doing like this. We are concentrating on indirect cost and overheads. We have the data, we have the books, we have tally. The simplest thing we can do is consolidate all the tallies into a single group company, put a columnar statement, remove the unwanted entries, keep only the entries, put it in a graph and circulate it to all the clients. They would love it. And if I am specific to the client, they would love it more. Okay, next. Let's go the other way. Now we can't be, any of you here from a Big Four? Two of you. See, it becomes very difficult to go on competing with Big Four because of two, three reasons. Their pockets are very deep. Their strategies are much deeper. And they have a huge data. If I and you are comparing transfer pricing documents, I use Prowess, which will give me 30 companies. They have 7 softwares. How do I sit and compete? And each subscription license is 40,000 bucks per month. 5 lakh rupees is a huge hit on my P&L. I won't be able to afford that. So we will have to make sure that whether we can break up this. I'll give you, relate this to our profession and then go there. Unilever had a huge amount of business, especially on shampoo business. Now Kevin Kerr made this smallest thing called the sachet shampoo, 1 rupee shampoo, 2 rupee shampoo. That froze the entire market. If you look at Procter & Gamble in US, had the largest share of toiletries, toilet products and things like that. But methods, I approached this author when I started the firm, I wrote to him, I would like to meet you. Can I come over? It's a cost of 70,000. First I went and met him. He gave me all the time in the world. So methods just changed the entire spectrum and told, can I make Harpic look beautiful? Can I make the toilet scrubber look beautiful? Today it's $150 million business. So if I can't compete against them, I'll compliment them. So take away, there are companies like Porus Munshi who are doing this and Methods. These are wonderful books. If we can take this and implement it in our organizations, it can be fantastic. What I could relate this to our organization is, you take a big four example, just know what I told you, they cannot have the data to compare it with 100 clicks because it's spread over 20 teams. Too much of data confidentiality is there. So in a owner-driven firm, I have data of all the clicks. What I can do, they cannot do. I can give comparisons among my clients what they can do. A simple example I can do is if I can make a list of refunds available from different assessees for different assessing officers and just tell this assessing officer refunds have come, this assessing officer refunds have not come. That talks everything else. Why is he not processing a refund? Why GST refund is not happening? That talks everything else. Next thing. Thought 5. Here is where we are all failing substantially in work. The client does not have any transparency in what we are doing. What is the link between Arvind Eye Care System and Pizza Hut? Pizza Hut is a company, wherever you go in the world, you get the same pizza. So Dr. Venkatachalam, he is no more now. He started Arvind Eye Hospital and he told that when pizza can be produced across the world in the same way, why can't I do eye surgeries like pizza? There is a video called Infinite Vision. Please do see it as a chartered accountant, one of the best videos. Infinite Vision of Dr. V. The entire office we based it based on that one video. How can I structure the entire office based on eye surgery? If an eye surgery can be done in a systematic way, why cannot we do tax audit in a systematic way? One example I'll tell you for revenue creation. How many of you stayed late for tax audits? How many didn't stay late for tax audit? I got some 4 or 5 hands. We do a very simple method. We are very happy if somebody comes late. If somebody comes in the month of September, I am the happiest. What we do in the proposal is, we put you come in the month of April, your fees is 1 lakh. You come in the May of May, it is 1 lakh 10. You come in the month of September, your fees is 1 lakh 85. Practically, we got 80% of, in the last 3 years, 80% of our tax audits are getting done before July. 80% is done before July. If somebody comes in September, please come. You are a cesarean case, ma'am. Please come. I am not a normal delivery. I am more happy. The more screwed up you are, I am more happier. Please come late. So we got a tax audit case which came in 20th of October. Oh, fantastic. Welcome. We don't like the early comers. At least I get rewarded for getting. And after working midnight oil, you are not having Diwali, you are struggling in the office, the client is padake podra. Why would I suffer for it? So this is a typical system where we created many systems to go in a method telling that we upload a document. You all have Google spreadsheets. All of you have Google Drives. Just upload a Google Drive and tell the client you fill up this Google Drive and come for audit. If the Google Drive is filled up and you give a color coding to the Google Drive, if everything 80% or 90% is green, my cost is 1 lakh. If 50% is green, my cost is 1 lakh 50. Because if you analyze your work time, majority of the time is going in data correction. Collect that voucher, collect this bill, collect that confirmation of balance, go to that creditor, balance is not there. Majority of the time is going only in this. If I can cut that out, this would be an ideal method for us. Thought 6. Similar ones, Titan and Citizen is a simple example, how they cross-match. How can a PwC and Guru and Jana cross-match? Both have their own markets, both have their own credentials. Dainik Bhaskar and Types of India, how did they cross-match? Surf was the leader in India, they almost gave run for their money. The same thing can happen in any of our practices. Thought 7. We'll run through Kahoot, it will take another 6 minutes. You want me to run down? I'll run that. You come here. Something is visible here. Okay. There's no screen? How do we get this? Okay.
the next one, we have a quiz on segment and positioning. Here also there are yes and no questions and answers. You can log in. So I think you will get a new pin for this. Again, go to classic pin. So start. Here we go. 2527020. So we are getting some players. Let's wait.
They had 79 last time.
So, on the last scene names, the fastest fingers first. A lot of them. I think so the great Mitchell has joined. We can start while all of the others. So should we wait? Can we start? Okay. Mr. Vivek is right now trying to come. We'll just wait for another 10 seconds. So we can go? Okay, great. So we have 18 questions. We'll quickly run through these questions and we'll see how it goes. Dependence on only one or two groups which give us major revenue. So is there a dependence on only one or two verticals which is going to give us the revenue within your firm? So which is that segment? Are you only depending on those one or two? Like real estate, is it going to cause a problem tomorrow when cash flows go down? So, yes, okay, we got, yes is 28, so the no is more, the no is lesser, so maybe we should think at expanding our options. So here we see Mr. Sridhar. The next question we have is, I have major dependence on traders. So like how I told real estate was one of the things. So are we depending too much on traders? Is it good or bad? Yes, it has its own pros and cons. I think traders would probably refer us more traders, depending on that. So 63 answers we already have. I think no is lot, which is then probably a good scenario. The next one is, Prakruti has climbed up, it said that. I have major dependence on startups. Are we all depending on startups for us to generate a lot of revenue? Startups that way is very good, where the startup ecosystem is going to probably give us more startups. But we have seen some of the startups close down also really fast, faster than they started. So are we only segmented in the startup space? Yes, no. No is a lot of them. But probably we can look at having startups also for our clientele. We can go to the next one. Prateek is the highest climber. I have major dependence on builder clients. This, many of us are facing an issue wherever builder clients are there. With the recent demo coming into picture, a lot of hit has been taken by these real estate. And we've been seeing a lot of IBC cases being filed also. So are we worried with builders? No, not bad. Then that is very good. So the next one. The next question we have, 20% of my clients pay 80% of the fees. This is most of the case. If this is the 20-80 rule, will hold good anywhere. So am I servicing that 20% of my clients for 80% of revenue? Am I taking care of that? Have we identified who those 20% are? That way, is it taking us in keeping them happy? Yes. This is mostly the scenario. So what we should probably do is go back and understand and spend more quality time in making that 80% revenue stronger. Next. Then we have, I have many individual files who pay only next year. Can they think of the situation where we take an advance at the time itself when they give us the documents and not wait for a one whole year of a cycle to get completed for them to pay our bills? This was a scenario when we also started, but today even the individual clients where they are handling, where directors are there, we make sure to take the fee in advance and not wait for a year.
Especially GST impact is there.
GST impact is especially we pay from our
pockets.
Absolutely. So we are paying salaries, we are paying the GST, which is a lot of cost hit. So please consider, if they are not going to give you 100% advance, take 50% advance at least. Next. Suhas has the highest answer streak of 6. Thank you, Suhas. I use company law work because clients get it done from other firms. So am I actually doing the corporate law work within the team itself, within the firm itself? Do we have an internal CS who is going to help us work with our clients? If we don't have, then probably we can think of having it. Because the moment when they start looking at other firms, they start thinking. So no, I do company law work, no, so yes is a good thing. Okay, next. 13th place, Dave is the highest. Next question. I do valuation work because clients get it done from other firms. I was told that no registered valuers, and because of that coming into picture, many of us who do not have people who have qualified, we are bound to go to other people and get the valuation work done. Can we look at doing it ourselves? Can we build that practice? Okay, that is good. Then the next question. I do structuring work because clients get it done from other firms. So structuring firms also is again another aspect. Can we look at building our own consulting practice within, where we can think of advising, where we get a lot of case laws and think of doing the structuring work. The loose spelling is wrong, L-O-S-E is the right spelling, so ignore the spelling. Yes, no, okay. Then the next question, I do tribunal work because clients get it done from other work firms. So what we have done here is the tribunal work, are we handling, do we have an NCLT practice, do we have a ITAT practice, are we outsourcing it to someone, are we getting it done through our friends firms, other member firms, can we think of handling the tribunal work ourselves? So no and yes, okay, and mostly it's all lying on the same lines. I use payroll services because clients get it done from other firms. Actually, payroll can be really a large practice where it's not just manual Excel sheets and structuring, but actually get them a HR tool like something like a Creative, like a Zoho, and you really structure it well. And even people with 5 people, 6 people also appreciate having a payslip online instead of manually generating, and you don't do mistakes. So payroll that way can be a large practice. Then the next question, I use GST related work because clients are getting it done from others. Again, GST is one of the practices. Where are we doing it? Are we outsourcing it? So compliance is that way. Most of it is yes and no only. So GST, I think most of us are doing it in-house. I continue to do work even without receiving fee. So when last year's audit fee is still not paid, and this year audit also I am going ahead, is it my mistake or is it the client's mistake? 100% it's our mistake. Do not sign the audit report without insisting on getting the last year's payment. Then everybody will come running to us and they will pay. And even if we are doing accounting work, month on month make sure we are receiving that cash flow. I would like to avoid clients who have stock adjustments. This is, I think, with the rising cases against CAs more and more being made responsible, stock adjustments tend to rule the roost. So is your banker simply giving loans and you are helping your client do the adjustments in stock? Let's be very careful about it. The next question, I have a clear target of customer segment, who will be my clients? So this segmentation is where we spoke of. Do we already have a study plan and a clear strategy on how and which segment are we going to focus? Do we want to be the Mercedes-Benz? Do we want to be the Bellingham? We can decide where we want to be. Okay, so most of them have figured out what is their segment. The next one, I am having most clients who come in the last date. So last date is November, follow that rule which Guru told, that we can charge them the highest and the premium when they come to you the last minute and make sure the client loses sleep and not you. So 33 say no, okay, yeah. Then the next one, probably the last question, the last but one. I have clients who do not change, every year they have the same problem. I think we have faced this, many of us face this. What audit issues I had last year, again a year after I look at it also, same issues I face. Can we have newer problems? Can it not just be the cold and cough every year? Probably a newer and better problems will keep us interested in doing the work. So yes is 37. Is crying baby getting more attention in my client field? this happens a lot. The client who actually is shouting at us, who is abusing, who is probably pushing us, he is given more attention than someone who's been so nice, who's paid all the fees. So the crying baby, we should not get more attention. We should see who is that crying baby, identify them. If possible, please send them out. So I think the next slide will be from Guru. Thank you everyone. So Shiva is the highest. So Shiva is the third, then Loki, then we have is Raj.
So, what was this exercise is, go back and see whether your segmentation is right. Are we serving clients whom we are just wasting our time, or are we doing this? And we generally request people to at least do this once in a quarter. Take your client list. We prepare a readout list. I don't want this place. Only when they go out of your office, they know what is your value. Till they go, don't go out of your office, they don't know your value. Some new areas what you can venture into. Couple of new areas. All of you know many, many new areas. I don't want to tell something like going to forensics or going to data analytics, because this at building the competency is almost impossible at this stage. So try to tell something what we can do at the current competencies what we have. What are the new areas we can do? Simple example, family arrangements. All of us work with families. We don't have a family arrangement agreement. A job can easily fetch us 2 to 3 lakh of rupees. Most families are disintegrating because of family arrangements. We all have experience in drafting shareholders agreements. We all have experience of handling Hindu undivided family. There are so many Marwadi families, Vaishya family businesses we do. Many businesses don't grow because they break. Brother breaks with father, father breaks with two brothers. It's a big mess and it's a very unfortunate mess. So, and all of us do family work. Because if the brother is there, he'll bring four families of them in your family. Brother-in-law joins you, father-in-law joins you. So you're doing work for everybody. And at the end of the day, when there is a problem, they all come to you to solve it. Just formalize this. Make it a family agreement. It includes like what will be your share. A guy goes to become a doctor, will he get something? A girl will go and get married, will she get something? That purposely is drawn. There will be so many confusions there, we could define something properly there. And we are already doing this. Not that we are not doing this. We are already doing it with our clients. In so many arbitrations meetings, we sit down. And if we sit down as a chartered accountant, we don't get a single rupee. If we sit down as a proper arbitrator, we get everything. The process is, the result is the same. Process alone is different. We are not positioning ourselves correctly. We can have who owns control. What is the vision document of a family? What is sibling? What will happen if intercaste marriages are there? What would happen if there is an adoption? What would happen if there is a death in the family? Who comes to board? There is only one shop, two brothers are running, each of the brother has two children. So the same shop, two brothers plus four children, six people. Kya kar rahe ho dukaan mein baithe, kuch bhi nahi kar. So we are losing out everything on that. Networking, the institute guidelines are very, very good in this. Networking have yielded fantastic results for people. There are two types of networking. One could be a global networking, one could be a domestic networking. There are totally in the forum of firms where EY, KPMG, PwC, all of their members of forum of firms. There are totally 27 firms in the forum of firms. Out of 27 in Bangalore, only 19 are there. So 27 minus 19, still 8 people don't have presence in Bangalore. So we just wrote to somebody called HLP in number 12. We wrote to them through the website and they came back. And they told, surprisingly, out of the 10,000 people, nobody has written to us. And they have been present in India for the last 19 years. We just became members of them 2 years ago. So extraordinary results. Out of 27, among the forum of firms, 19 only are there, balance 7 is there. Other than the forum of firms, international networks are many more. There are more than 60 international networks. What could be the benefits of this? Referral practice for inbound and outbound clients. Our institute does not allow us to pay referral fees to a non-chartered accountancy firm. That's perfectly okay, but the institute allows us to pay subscription fees. So subscription fees can range between 2 lakhs to 2.5 lakhs. That could be a very good area. And business development is a fantastic job. We do valuations for companies in US. In India, for FCGPR valuation, we get a lakh of rupees. For a US company, for the same valuation, which is not FCGPR but standard principles, valuation principles are the same around the world. How many of you are registered values here? A fantastic scope is there for registered values. I'll give you a website, please go and log in there. There are enough of jobs coming from there. I have my partner who is a registered value, he is a member of that. He gets at least one or two jobs every month. And the fee can range anything between $4,500 to $5,000. That's a pretty good business. Young partners program, most of the young partners, any of them, either way they travel to Bali. Either way they travel to Bangkok.
What is the website?
I don't remember the website, I'll keep you posted. Either way they are going for fun. So instead of that, the young partners can be sponsored by the firm, go there for young partners programs. International exposure is fantastic. If nothing works out, at least we'll emulate their punctuality. Domestic branding is very good. If I go to a client and tell I'm a partner of HLB, I can serve you in 130 countries. It is much better chances to get the client than just Kulai Kuronjan. The options of getting the client are many, many more. Work culture is different. Last year we could send two of our people to, one person went to Papua New Guinea, one person went to Kenya. Fabulous experience. And they've been there with us happily growing since then. Now the entire organization is looking, can I go to Brazil next? There's no cost, you just have to bear the flight cost and the salary. They bear the flight cost and salary, they come and stay in your house, your employees go and stay in their house. Clean sink. You're getting good practices, you're having employee retention. Employee retention has been a fantastic term because an employee wants to come and see our big organization. People tell we don't get people. But when we go to HR strategies next, as soon as this, we get around 30 resumes every day. We don't have any dearth of resumes. Risk bearing capability increases, dependence on one client reduces, pooling of resources, standard stuff. Next. International presence, extended knowledge. Next. Better quality of deliverables. Their quality of deliverables are fantastic. The same balance sheet, they put it in a different format. The same valuation multiple presentation is different. When I take you the text slides, I'll show you. Just one small slide could increase everything. See, jump. We can do services like being demand agents. We can do service corporate law. There are so many law firms who don't do corporate law work. We do white labeling for them. What do you mean by white labeling? I'll tell them, for all your clients, I'll do corporate law. We'll work on your email ID. We will not use Gurujana email ID. I'll use XYZ, Amarchal Mangardas, Indus Law, JSA Law. We will communicate with your client. You don't want to do corporate law work, we'll be happy to do. A company law work retainer fee, when it goes through a lawyer, can be up to 20,000 books a month. As opposed to when we go directly, it is 8,000 rupees a month. So in corporate law work, you can almost bill 2.5 3 lakh rupees if you go through a lawyer. If you go in as a chartered accountant, you bill anything between 80,000 to 120,000 for the same job. So because positioning is totally different. Next thing. Shareholder agreement compliances. All of them do shareholders agreement. The law firms do the shareholding agreements. But nobody is doing the compliances. Shareholder agreements are about 40 clauses. Who is following up the 40 clauses? Nobody. As a statutory auditor, it is not your role. As an internal auditor, it is not process related. It's a contractual agreement. So we approach the investors and tell, I do shareholders agreement compliance. Make an Excel spreadsheet, go through their books, tick, 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 not tick, matter done. And the investors are paying this, not the portfolio companies. So it's very good jobs. VC custodian services. Investors, one standard investor will invest anything in 60 to 80 companies. In Bangalore, there are more than serious investors, 90. 90 serious investors are there in Bangalore. Each investor is investing in 60 companies. We just go to them and tell, look, this is my platform, I am offering this service to you. We can take care of your compliances. That means I'll collect all the shareholder agreements, I'll collect all the board minutes, I'll collect the balance sheets. And they don't even have original share certificates. After the signing is done, they're gone. When a legal issue comes, only everything starts. So we collect all this, put it in a dashboard, put it in a Google Drive, make it fancy, color it, give it to them. They're happy, I'm happy. VC custodian services is doing very well. Data room creation. Many clients in a traditional practice still 4% balance sheet could cut season, photocopy could cut season. In a standard format, it's only a data room creation. For a corporate, if I can create a data room for all the taxes, all your GSTs, board minutes, corporate law minutes, employee agreements, everything, put it in a Dropbox, paid Dropbox, data room creation can almost cut you a one creation can charge, you can charge up to 5 to 6 lakhs per startup. So even if you can create two or through data room creation jobs, and there are nobody who is doing this. There is nobody who is doing data room creation. For example, NASCOM Foundation in Diamond District is planning to set up 10,000 startups. Right now there are only 940 startups. Even if all of us approach, we can't serve the 940 startups. And out of 940 startups, even if I can pick up 5%, 45 startups for data room creation through my networking and branding and the way I would put it up, 5 lakhs into 45 companies, I can build 2 crores over a period of 2 years. This is a very, very large practice. And when most of the acquisitions will happen, the big 4 auditors would come in. Data room is not ready, due diligence cannot be done. If due diligence cannot be done, investment cannot happen. Conditions subsequent to conditions precedent will become a mess. So this is a very large activity. Please skip up. 4. Directorship services. We have never gone back, step foot telling directorship services is risky. I am an educated chartered accountant, I am a lawyer. If I cannot defend a company, what do I expect a trader to do? A startup, if you are an investor, nominee, investors don't want to get into the board. Investors are always only board observers. As per the shareholders agreement, they have a nomination right. So we go to the shareholder, we go to the VC circle. In the VC circle, we find out who are all of the investors. This is the investment which has happened during the year. Pay 100 rupees, download the special resolution, download the NJT form, you will get the shareholders agreement. In the shareholders agreement, you will see who are the directors who are there in the board, who are the observers. Make a list, put an article student. He will go to 100 companies. He is happy doing this work because he is bored of ticking. He is jumping. I am doing something valuable. Make a list of these 100 companies. Write back to them. These 100 companies, you don't have a nominee director. I can provide the nominee director, provided you give me D&O insurance, provided you do the following. Fabulous business. A nominee director where a startup funded is there can go up to 4 to 5 lakhs per year as fees. If it is a US subsidiary, it can be anything between 6 to 8 lakhs. The fees is fantastic in this. Vendor due diligence review. Even before anything, we'll try to go and do a due diligence next week. IBC, all of you know IBC is a fabulous practice. Even though if you are not an IBC specialist, you are not past IBC, all of you who have done 10 years and above, it's a fantastic green field. If you get into IBC, go to IBC website. Just tell your article student, keep an eye on the website, find out who all petitions are getting admitted. As soon as the petition is admitted, you are there. It's not like an ambulance chaser's practice, it's a professional practice. One IBC case, two IBC cases can be the revenue of your full firm for 1 year. And death of the old times. The old times are dying very, very fast. I'll skip this very fast. Incorporation, we used to charge 150,000 rupees. Now you can't even charge more than 30,000 bucks. Tax scrutiny is becoming e-scrutiny. GST registrations is a click away. Incorporation of company has become productized. 4,000 rupees people are doing incorporation. How long will I be struggling only in that job? So you can skip this too, it will take a lot of time. Bulk tax returns. We used to do bulk tax returns. Now it is dead. ICICI is telling, I'll give you gold card plus 3 tax returns. How will you compete against that? Totally dead. Multi-state VAT understanding, dead. Bank audits, it's about to die. Stock take is not required at all. Now RFID will take care of stock take. Consolidated audit. Now we have GST audit revenue, we have tax audit revenue, TP revenue, statutory audit revenue, 100 revenues. If at all the government, which 100% will happen within this 2 quarters, they'll remove 4 audits and just still fill 1 audit. All our revenues will fall down by 40%. It just pick, and it's logical. Because the same P&L account we are doing GST. Same P&L account we are doing tax audit. Same P&L account we are doing statutory audit. Same P&L account we are doing TP audit. There's no big rocket science. So the government has to just convert all these 4 audits into one spreadsheet. 40% of our profession goes. So we have lost, but the profession has gained. FIPB is gone. The number of returns are gone. GST is gone. GST registration used to be 30,000 bucks. Now it's a click away. Letter of undertaking is gone. LUT used to be 20,000 bucks. Now there is nothing called LUT. ESI limits are raised. Next thing. RBI FDI reporting has become super easy. Demonetization may be a failure, but the black money monger is out of the profession. He's out of the profession anymore. So these are a few strategies to check. Okay, we have another 20 minutes. We have two interesting concepts: HR, how do we retain people, technology. Then we will try to wrap it up as fast as possible. Please bear with us.
HR strategies, we have just focused on very simple things here. We have to move from just payroll to being HR. So it's not just processing salaries in the firm, it's about actually spending time for the employees. It is not a month-end salary sheet activity anymore. So what we have said here is, are you only concentrating on department, clients, SOS, urgent works or the work alone? Or are you spending some time for the HR activity also? Please spend some time, is the idea. IBM versus Infosys branding. Why we put this here is, IBM did a branding a few years back. What they did is, they focused on branding it amongst the employees. What Infosys did is, they were branding outside. So that way it is important for us to actually brand the activities for an employee to be here and show a growth path. What are our internal branding strategies? What could be there? Belongingness in the organization. Create a belongingness. So if you have to organize a festival, you don't be on the forefront. Get them to do the activities. Relationship of left employees. How many of us are keeping in touch with our alumni? It is important because today at least 10% of our business comes as a reference from the people who left us and gone and have joined industries. So can you go back and create a database of your people and connect with them? Pride in the organization, creation of the culture internally. If now any of us decide to go and do a cultural activity and a branding activity, probably run this questionnaire amongst the employees itself. Ask them, what would you suggest, where do you think we should be? Then they will feel more involved. And even if one aspect of what they told us we implement, they will stay with us for life. They will feel that they value our suggestions a lot. Song for the office. Can we think of having an anthem? Can we think of having a good news board in the office where if there is some good news, people come and write. They celebrate what is happening. Then today's special at office. So can there be a today's special? Somebody's birthday we celebrate. Then somebody got a new bike we celebrate. Things like that. Can we actually celebrate a today's special every day just given good news? A nostalgia book. Can we create a book where from where we were to where we are and where we will be? Can we sort of create a journal within the team and circulate for all of us to see? Can we do a vision exercise where all of them sit together and do a vision exercise? 360 degree review or town hall meetings. So it is very important for us to understand things from the perspective of the person who is working in the organization also, not just keep framing the policies. So that way 360 degree review will help a lot in them also feeling a part of the organization. So there was one pool where we have mentioned how we do the PMS. It's not playing, so I can ignore that. Integration of values.
It's not playing.
It's not
playing. Just go. It's a nice tool.
So what we have done in this tool is employee PMS used to be a big umbrella.
It's playing. Yeah.
So people never used to get their PMS done on time. So I have had people who left the organization because they didn't get the salary increments on time. Then what we have done, we have devised a very simple tool. Like 11 points we give, 11 points we rate. So if we tell quality of work is one of the reviews, am I delivering my work on time is one of the criteria. So probably if any of them is interested, we'll post the sheet on how we are doing the PMS. Each one of them will actually rate their own rating. So how is my quality of work? What is my deliverables? Am I doing it on time? Is there escalation from client? How is my communication with my peer group? How is my communication with clients? Am I coming to office on time? Am I the last person to leave from office? So these sort of tools are already there. So
you are doing monthly basis or
not? So this is done on a yearly basis. Whenever their PMS is due, that time we do that tool. So now PMS is being done in just 5-10 minutes and we are done with that exercise. So we don't have to worry. How this we do is 8% is the standard increment we give to all of them. Then based on the rating, we next decide 50%, 20%, 25%, and then it goes. So if a partner has rated someone 70% and the employee has rated himself 90, we sit together and arrive at a percentage and tell, this is the standard increment, go ahead. Here what we are saying is, when somebody is hired into the firm, look at whether they understand the technology and whether they are profitable. Rewards and leadership will not factor when we are hiring someone. Sustainability, when we are thinking of someone staying with us, then we should reward them. So you understand, we should understand where we want our employees. then the reward in rewarding also is one of the ways we promote people. So promotion also is one of the rewards we can pass on to our employees. So this we can understand. And then leadership. So leadership is here where leaders are doing a succession planning and can people be shown a growth. Most of us complain that we don't get employees, or probably there is a lot of awareness in the market and we are not able to attract the right talent. So when we are calling for interviews, can we think of the simple aspects? Can a management team member only spend some time on this? Interviewing should be an experience. So even today I've had people who talk about their first day when they walked into the firm. So can we create such an experience for them? Simple things, give them a bottle of water, give them a puck, chocolate, probably give them a flower, anything. So can we think of creating an experience for the employees when they walk into the office? Google forms for interviews. Today abundance is available in the open source software. Can we create a Google form where people just key in the basic details on their own? So we show them that it's a high-tech office where their name they can put, they can upload their photo, then whether they have their pan. All those things, can we create a Google form? Team photos. So these team photos in the office, can we put up team photos within the organization where when the people walk in, they'll have a sense of belonging, okay, tomorrow my photo will also be there on the wall. It is a big deal actually. Then how are you treated? Are we treating them with respect? Are we making them wait? Then security of front office. So if we have that, then make sure we educate our security of front office, or one of them should be there to receive the people who walk in. What I see when I come for an interview is very critical. Then there are some AI tools which we can use for interviews. This is going to be a good exercise when people walk in. I can skip the cover. Then there are tech strategies over to you.
Better skip the tech because we have less time. Actually, this is a 2-hour session by itself, but can you start morning? Enough of tech stuff is there. The only idea we are telling in tech is if it is above 500 bucks per month, it is not worth it. If it is below 500 bucks per month, we have 100 tools. Keep in touch with us, we'll give you many offers. Next year. I think video is working here, looks like.
Ignore this.
These are some tools. Perfuse is a good tool, what all of you can use. It's a single tool which helps you do a computation of statement of taxes. If you are doing individual practice, please go and subscribe for Perfuse. It's a free version, paid version. Paid version is 600 bucks per annum. It will go to credit card division, it will go to all the banks, it will go to all the mutual funds, LICs, housing loan statements, it will pull all the data on its own. It will prepare a trial balance and give it to you. You can do professional work instead of breaking statements. You don't have to break for statements, it will automatically come. But it is giving you a trial balance. When it is giving you a trial balance for free, the trial balance is 600 rupees an annum. And by the way, we don't have any interest in any of these tools. We just use this. Next thing. This is a tool which we called as Vivid. It's a proprietary tool. When a multinational company prepares a presentation, it's a fantastic presentation. So the amount of fees which they charge is to that extent. But what we generally try to do is, can we do it in a much faster way? This tool can do an equal presentation in 45 seconds. It can create a fabulous document and give it to the client. To just take a second's time, if you do a 143 bracket 2 scrutiny, and give him an assessment order of 2 pages and bill him 1 lakh, he'll never give you money. But if you can give all the case histories you have done, all the questions you have asked, risk assessments you have done, all the working analysis, it will become a 1,000-page file. This document can create the 1,000-page file within a matter of 45 seconds, give those 1,000 pages in a PDF format to the client, automatically there is an increase of fees. These are some solutions which can be freely adopted. Go next, you can skip this. Google Forms can be created for thousands of activities. Power BI is a fantastic tool. Please don't venture doing it. It is not in our competency. Only a student can only do it. A fresh, newly engaged chartered accountant, I can't fathom an idea of doing something like this. It's a messy tool for me. But these guys can do fantastic jobs. An example I could give you is, next. If you look at this slide, it can give a cluster-wise detailed city. Suppose I am doing an audit of Lakme. I am doing an audit of Puma. There are 100 shops. If I have to consolidate the report and give it to everybody, for each shop they are paying me 8,000 bucks. 100 into 8 is 8,000. My cost of doing this is 12 lakhs. But my income is only 8 lakhs. That totally fails it. But with the Power BI tool, if I can engage even second PUC, second BCom students, they can do the store audits just on a mobile. They can just go click. We did a fixed asset verification for Shell. All India. we employed people in second POC, first BCom, and that everything was mobile based. They just have to go there, click a photo, send it here. And the school will cost you 50-60,000 bucks to develop, not more than that. Next. Next, we'll jump this. Some thoughts of how to get business. Sir was very eager on that, but unfortunately we are having very less time. A simple thing, if a client is happy, you're only doing tax, can I do everything for him? Next. If you have a satisfied customer, you go and plot all the services, what you can do for a client. One Excel spreadsheet could give you an answer for this. Can I get an influencer? Most business comes through an influencer, but we seldom put any effort in getting business. We want to sit in one place and become a big guy. That would never work. Who is an influencer? A VC player is a fantastic influencer. And VC players are available. 800 VCs are in the country. And every VC I meet, they have the same problem. There is nobody else to do work for me. Only through VC connects, we have worked for 150 people per year. So much work is available, there is dearth of people who want to do this work. So establishing a connect with a VC is very important. It won't work if you take a flyer and go, you won't even get met. So you have to work out your strategies how to meet. We had some funny strategies of getting PF transferred and we got in connection with the VCs. We got some funny strategies of getting their income tax refund and we got connected. So that's a simple place. PE players is a very simple place. Association with senior advocates can be a fabulous thing. Senior advocates would give large necessary amount of businesses. And the fees can be 3-4 times than what we can quote. An incorporation commit to a senior advocate, if I do compliances for them, I can charge 50-60,000 as opposed to 20,000 if I charge something. In Bangalore alone, there are so many advocate firms, at least 100 of them are there. There is absolutely no CAOs associated with anybody. There are very few people. Corporate CFOs and independent directors. Independent directors, we send them the analysis of their balance sheet free of cost. We take the DIN number of the director, download all the DIN numbers, see which all companies they are directors, and they tell, okay, these are the number of companies which has not filed returns. Send it back to them. And we write in bold, please approach your chartered accountant, don't approach us. But news spreads very fast. Next. God is busy, can I help you? NGO space is something which chartered accountant shun. No chartered accountant wants to be in NGO space. Please keep your eyes open on FCRA registrations. FCRA is a public website. You have an access, I have an access. If you can have access on FCRA website and know which is the trust which has got FCRA approval, they would need professional services. Chartered accountants are not going there. People like Bill Gates and Melinda Gates foundations are funding billions of dollars. And recently we got 4 clients only in this space by doing this. There are in Bangalore accelerators and incubators, if you type in just there, you get in excess of 75. Accelerators and incubators. There are hundreds of companies in the accelerators and incubators, there is nobody to serve them. It's empty space. Next. Ego is a fascinating monster. Don't leave this ego go out. Get people to come to your office. He sent 10 people. Why don't you go and meet the CEO, take his interview and come? Why don't you go to this gentleman, meet him and come? Go to this commissioner, take picture with him and come. Kids are super happy. Chartered accountants, youngsters, articles are delighted to go there. But at the same time, the guy who's getting felicitated is also happy. Even if they get a bouquet, I'm very, very happy. So ego is a super monster. It is up to us how do we use it. Call them for office lectures, call them for interviews, call them for meetings. Get your people to listen to them. Ask your people to approach them for career guidance. Whoever has achieved the top has got enough time. Everybody will give you time. I have a few more minutes. I wrote a book called God in the Boardroom. It sold around 10,000 copies. In case possible, please do buy it. That is an interview of global leaders. So when we wrote this book, I did not even know one person. HDFC chairman, ICICI chairman, Britannia chairman, Coke chairman, I didn't know anybody. I just called them. They all gave me interviews. Their interviews in the form of a book called God in the Boardroom. The advantage of this is 10,000 boardrooms have my book. What more branding would I require? Next. Ego is a satisfying man. we are so under 150 chartered accountants here. We tried this ripple effect only in an area called Jainagar. All of us are suffering for fees. Instead of charging 2 lakhs, all of us are struggling charging 75,000. At the same time, we also creep, how come MLC firms only get 4 lakhs? The same job we are also doing. The issue is there is a ripple effect. If just in this audience, we did this in Jainagar and also Ahmedabad seminar, we put a foot down and told, okay, at least among 150 of us, this is the minimum fees we charge. About 75 didn't bother, but 75 bothered. Within a period of 3 years, we could map the entire professional fees had gone up by 40-50%. It is just going to be how we are going to position regarding the fees. Here, if I am going in a direction where you are charging 1 lakh, I'll charge 75,000, that's called chicken leg. We'll reach nowhere. Next day. We implement this quite often. And overcrowded specializations. How do we get work from UK? How do we get work from Germany? How do we get work from... Go to the state commissions. They are waiting for people. I have not seen a single chartered accountant in any of the state commissions. I have been going there for 7 years. First year nothing happens, second year nothing happens, third year you get a lead, fourth year you get a lead. Now from only this 5 Chamber of Commerce we get so much work. It's now we have reached a stage, I don't want work, please stop. And all of these are mostly free. Canadian Trade Commission is free, Israeli Trade Commission is free. Israeli's number of companies coming into Bangalore is humongous. We need to make one effort to go out of Chickpet and stand there. But we don't want to work. And there would be boring lectures, let us go. There is a Japanese Trade Commission exactly opposite the Income Tax Department. Exactly opposite Income Tax Department in the Prestige building. They telecast Japanese movies. I go and sit down in the Japanese movies, I don't understand one word. 2 hours, I do WhatsApp and come out. I did that for 4 weeks. 5th week, I got 2 plates. There's no stoppage, there's nobody visiting this. These are all green pastures, waiting to be harvested. Thought 7. Branding, we can't be doing the branding of websites. We can't be doing the standard branding of visiting cards. We would need to be known in the world. Can I have a paperless office? I am the first in the billion. We told we are the first in a billion. We are chartered accountants. Our firms are so small. We are not global corporation of 500,000 crores. We are small firms. Can't we publicize and tell, oh yeah, I'll file my return on the first of the year. Such a big publicity. Everybody is telling, how do you file your returns on the first of the year? Yeah, I file. Portal is not open. Yeah? There is a method to do it. Portal is not open. Go to the commissioner's office, file a physical return, distribute sweets and tell, sir, don't bother about it. I only want a photograph. That's about it. Next. Marketplace target is narrow. We review listed company balance sheets and write to the independent directors. We are all chartered accountants. We know how to review balance sheets. Download 5 balance sheets. Review it. Comparative analysis and view it. We do NIN number analysis. Download 10 people's NIN numbers. Write to them. You are a director in 10 companies. 2 companies have not been filing the form. They have not filed the AOC. You are in trouble. Please approach your chartered accountant. Don't come to me. I don't have time. But tomorrow he'll come back one day. Don't come to me. I have time. Security charges are. Exchange rate is high. We go and help clients. How do you get the best balance sheet of ICAI? Sir, ICAI, he'll recommend best balance sheets. But that's a fantastic business development tool. Go to GE or anywhere and tell the balance sheet has got the following points, the institute has given 200 points, out of which only 120 points you have given, 80 points you have not done. I can help you doing that. Huge business development talent. Provident Fundry, competitors' balance sheet. Go to your client, he has got competitors. He does not know what is happening in competition. 100 rupees, download the balance sheet. Give it to an article student, ask him to prepare an Excel spreadsheet, particulars 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, put a graph, dump it, done, one day's job, 1000 rupees, enough business development happens in this. And when we do business development, there is so much work, I am not exaggerating when I tell you on an average day, we send 6 proposals. And please tell you not given a single rupee discount. You won't come otherwise, buzz off. I tell you, your fees are more higher than before, absolutely yes. It's much higher than most of them. If you want to come otherwise, I don't need. So the more you tell, no, the more you get. All of us tried for cricket match tickets. We never got. We got lati charge. Today we get cricket match passes in our office, we don't have time. So when we want clients, we don't get. When we don't want clients, we get. Simple analogy. Next. corporate going into entrepreneurship is a very big business. Anybody in the corporate at age of 40, 45, 46 wants to get out and start something on his own. He has made 5 crore of rupees. He's thinking he can do mentoring. He cannot do mentoring. Nobody is listening to his mentoring. People are fully busy. We all know everything. But every corporate guy is coming out to do business. So instead of going and contacting the businessmen to get business, if you can go and contact the corporates to get business, how a startup happens. CPE seminars in Infosys, CPE seminars in Texas, CPE seminars in IBM. Recently I went to CPE seminar in IBM, fantastic facility. I was floored. There were 8 people. I was happy. Here we are 158 people. But one day that 8 will convert. But talking to 150 of you, I will not even get a single client. But 8 of them will get one conversion. Statutory audit, I have a pain. You can jump through screen, this requires a lot more explanation. Of course, when you have to do all this, before you reach in a position to get business, the pride has to be trusted. A turnaround pride cannot be getting business. The pride has to look nice. The pride has to look honest. The pride has to look trustworthy. That is why the first 5 chapters were, can I do organization building? Can I do partnership firm building? Can I do HR strategies? Can I do technology strategies? Can I make myself clean? Legal licenses. Create all the 5. The pride is ready. Then go out and get these 14 thoughts. Out of 14 thoughts, if you implement 3 thoughts properly and honestly, you should be able to get a turnover of 1 crore of rupees. Between 150 of us, we should be able to raise 150 crores. But the problem is we don't want to do the first 5, we want to do the last 6. That would never work. The result will depend on the process. Yes. Thank you very much. I have exceeded by 9 minutes. If anything is there, let's catch it offline. Thanks for the patient hearing. All of you have sat for 3 hours. Highly obliged by all of you.
Thank you very much.
I request members to wait for 2 more minutes to conclude the session. We had a fantastic session. I feel it's a 360 degree view of strategy making, but we cannot digest in a single session. Definitely it is indigestion because so much inputs are in this, sir. We have to conduct like workshop, I feel. give them a big round of applause for sharing the self-learned and practically implemented experiences. Really were amazed, and thank you very much, sir. We thank you on behalf of Bangalore branch of ICA. May I request our chairman to present a gift voucher to Guru sir and official liquidator, they called for empanelment in ROC. Those are interested, you can register. Thank you.